as much as I could stomach of the DNC. And it made me feel embarrassed for this country. I'll be completely honest with you. It made me really feel sick to my stomach. That bizarre, reanimated zombie Clinton stumbling around, and everything he said was a lie. And about how Hillary goes into a country and fixes everything when everywhere she goes, she destroys, whether it's Serbia or Bosnia-Herzegovina or Libya or Syria or Egypt. I mean, I could go on and on and on. The destabilization programs that dynamic duo of crime have carried out. And him talking about the love of my life. It was truly sick. And then watching C-SPAN so I could kind of get behind the scenes shots of the people there. I've got to say, you get invited to a party and you get there and it's got a weird feeling and the people are all kind of creepy and weird looking. And I'm just going off how they look, but I mean, you know, creepy acting, sneaky looking, evil looking. Watching the body language of the Democratic Party operatives, they just look like a group of criminals. They look like a bunch of mental patients mixed in with criminals and pedophiles and slime bags. With Republicans, you've kind of got swollen guys in pinstripe suits, cigars, but and they've got their own seediness. And that's kind of the Republican establishment that's being swept out right now. So I've been to a lot of RNCs. This one with Trump had a grassroots feeling of electricity. And gone were the establishment Republicans almost entirely. It was extremely powerful. And I've talked to some of our crew who's going to be joining us later today. And they picked up on the very same thing. And just watching the sliminess of the Black Lives Matter race pimps there to distract African Americans from how their unemployment's doubled, how they've been totally forgotten because the Democrats know they got them, how they're invoking total race, trying to turn the black population into like the Black Klan. It was absolutely painful, painful, painful. And then reviewing clips this morning that we're going to be going over, it was just incredible. And then the stories on Infowars.com, the stories on PrisonPlanet.com, the stories on DrudgeReport.com are unbelievable. Our crew got the footage from three different angles. Other media got it as well. In fact, one clip of a place from other media because it's better quality. And it's Black Lives Matter saying, get to the back, white people. You're not allowed to be in the front of our demonstration. Literally inverting what happened to Rosa Parks, saying, get to the back of the bus, lady. I mean, the irony. Whites ordered the back of crowd at Black DNC march. And at colleges all over the country, they are the colleges are segregating. And the same thing's happening for Muslims, for Black Americans. This is the divide and conquer strategy. You see, when there was a vast majority of whites, until the abolitionists and Republicans and Christians broke the back of institutional racism to a great extent, it was still there, but broken. They would play this broken strategy, the Democrats would. But as soon as the Republicans defeated that in the late 50s and early 60s, they switched to, oh, we're the party of the minorities now. And as soon as minorities hit a majority, which they are in most areas, boom, now they're flipping back to race. And man, I tell you, you see ignorant racist white people, it's embarrassing. It is just as disgusting to see a bunch of racist black people. I mean, it is really creepy and weird and bizarre. And what's even worse is you got mainstream media telling you it's good and it's up there on the stage being pushed as something wonderful. Now, this is the kickoff of the 28-hour Sleeping Giant broadcast. We haven't put the schedule out yet. There's a big surprises coming up today. You'll definitely want to share the link at Infowars.com/giant. Because there's two different feeds. I'm going to explain that when we come back. And the game has begun. The gate is open. The horses are out. The 28-hour marathon, once-a-year broadcast, is live. On the 27th day of July, 2016, I'm your host, Alex Jones. We're going to be live here for the next 28 hours, as I just said. We have some special reports we're obviously going to be airing. We've got some highlights, obviously, of the RNC and DNC. We'll have our reporters live on the ground throughout the next 28 hours. We have a lot of special surprise guests joining us. In the next hour or so, we will put a schedule up, though, at Infowars.com/giant. And I want to be clear for folks. Infowars.com/giant has the feed of the 28-hour broadcast. We will also have a refeed loop of the official 4 hours of the main show for folks that want to be able to go in and see any of those news-making interviews that break. And one reason I do that is there's actually TV stations and other systems out there that actually get the show off of that HD archive every day, not just the TV satellites, the radio satellites, and other systems. A lot of TV stations, a lot of cable systems, a lot of radio stations, strangely enough. I started doing TV to try to get on TV stations, but what happens is radio stations, a lot of our affiliates end up picking up the nightly news every night, and a lot of them are going to be picking up large sections, and of course you're welcome to, it's free to air, of the 28-hour broadcast, much of it commercial-free. So you just play your commercials wherever you want, or when we play a video or something, just stations, have at it, enjoy yourselves. Again, we're all about freedom here. We just want to get the message out. So whether you want to play excerpts of the show or whether you want to carry the whole 28 hours or whatever you want to do, right now it's about fighting the globalists and exposing the coronation of Hillary, who officially got the nomination last night, despite the fact that she probably only got, from the numbers we've crunched, 35% of the vote. Sanders annihilated her and in 10 states, won by more than 20 points, and it just didn't matter. It just didn't matter because she got the superdelegates. Unbelievable. We've got all sorts of stories about Trump supporters being shot, being stabbed, being attacked, especially black and Hispanic Trump supporters. There is cult-like bullying going on by just mobs of basically thugs from MS-13 to black power groups. It's just crazy. It's absolutely crazy to see the president and the mainstream media trying to foment division in this country. We're going to be breaking it all down. Trump just finished, coming up a few minutes ago, a lengthy speech from Florida. We're going to be airing some excerpts of that today, obviously. We also have, with huge breaking news, Roger Stone joining us coming up here in about 15, 20 minutes. David Knott will be popping in via Skype from the DNC. Matt Bracken on the massive increase in Islamic attacks. There's like three or four a day now. It was once a month, then once a week, then once a day. It's like four or five a day. And that's what we know of. I mean, I've just got stacks here. It's incredible. And you know, British children found in cages of Islamics. I mean, it's just, it is hell on earth. And then William Binney, former technical director of the National Security Agency, one of the biggest whistleblowers in history, will be joining us. And then we've got everybody from Billy Corgan of Smashing Pumpkins to Dinesh D'Souza to just so many others joining us. It's going to be a huge, huge 28-hour global transmission. So obviously, this is about activism. You may know all about the New World Order and more than I do, but the point is that the understanding of global government and stealth government was known by patriots 50 years ago, and they fought it and got made fun of and ridiculed and demonized and audited and arrested and murdered in many cases. But it doesn't matter. Today in national polls, 90 to 92% in every scientific poll believe elements of the government killed JFK. 90-plus percent of Americans in Gallup polls want the Federal Reserve audited and or abolished, and they know it's private. 15 years ago, I was ridiculed in the New York Times saying that it was not private. You could not even get people to admit that there was a carbon tax plan 8-9 years ago. Al Gore would go before Congress and say it was a conspiracy theory when he owned the main carbon company set to make trillions. They're not playing games. And the good news is we're not either. They're just lying to us, and stonewalling isn't working. So they've now gone into complete and total panic mode. And have now doubled down in lying to the most weaponized lying I've ever seen. Total inversion of reality. And again, who cooked up the scam when he was a senator with Ken Lay of Enron. Look it up for yourself. Enron environmentalism, the carbon credit scam, pumps millions of tons more greenhouse gases into the atmosphere, set to make trillions every decade. And you can actually go see ATR.org. Democratic platform calls for carbon tax globally. Donald Trump wants to stop that. So does Vladimir Putin. We'll be talking about that with Roger Stone coming up. But before we go any further, I just want you to know that Bill Clinton is now dodging subpoenas. Oh, yes, there are subpoenas out for Bill Clinton. And so I'm just going to stop right there. Roger Stone's coming up in about, again, 16, 17 minutes. Let me just calmly give you the headlines that we will cover in detail today. Let me just go through these for everybody. Charges dismissed against Baltimore police officers in Freddie Gray case. Will there be riots now that we learned that three of the police officers were black and that the judge dismissing the charges is black? No one's defending excesses of police. It happens. It's wrong. There are people on power trips that become police. It's wrong. It's a globalist diversion from the big issues to get us fighting with each other, period. Freddie Gray case, charges against three remaining officers dropped. Shooting deaths of police up 78% this year, troubling to Memorial Fund. Funny, though, that when they had Black Lives Matter victims' families up there, people who died in questionable shootings, they didn't have all the widows of dead cops up there and everybody come together and hug and say, let's work on bringing communities together. They didn't mention the 2,000-plus people shot in the first 7 months of this year in Chicago, almost all of them black, black on black, 500-plus dead black, because the cops are pulling out. They're not going to those areas. And quite frankly, I don't blame them. I was out there at a Black Lives Matter deal, and there were communist people open carrying out there, which is fine. We had ours to open carry. And it was a really creepy feeling to know I was a target when I went in there and charged in there and said it's wrong to randomly kill cops. I got to really get what it feels like to have people surrounding me, not knowing when a bullet's going to hit me. Can you imagine being a cop just writing tickets or going to a house disturbance or whatever, or you get called to the scene of stuff at a robbery at a liquor store. There's 20 people calling for you to die right there. I wouldn't take that job in a million years. A million years. And the point is, we have the numbers. There's more cops getting killed than there are people in questionable shootings. And the issue here is the globalists want the police to be our oppressors. We need to try to be friends with them, take our communities back and come together and not be idiots. But I'm sorry, I said I just cover headlines. It's hard to do. I'm going to do this later. Let me just get into them. Because this all paints a picture, these articles that go together, okay? 990 people shot by police in 2015 total. 258 were African Americans. And it turns out more than a third were shot by other black officers. I mean, you start doing the numbers, man. You're maybe 50, 60, 70 questionable shootings. Good. Put those cops in prison. But is it the biggest issue in the galaxy? No, no, no. Again, a total diversion from our government trying to start World War III with the Russians and putting jihadists in control of Syria who killed over 250,000 Christians alone and a couple hundred thousand other Muslims. They let in 0.3%. That's the latest numbers from the feds, Christians. Syria's 20%. They won't let them out. They're not letting Shiites out either. They only let Sunnis out because they're those that failed to take over. This was an invasion plan. 250,000 dead Christians, and baby, you don't hear anything out of the DNC on that. And it's like a pageant. You know, the poor Black Lives Matter folks think they're getting attention like, I'm on the stage. At least Oprah Winfrey gave folks a car to create the illusion she cared about her audience. But they're on the stage like, we're getting attention. You care about us. No, you're being put out there with a false argument to be scapegoated later. I'm sorry. I got to stop. This video is coming up. It's on Infowars.com. Whites ordered to back of the crowd at black DNC march. White people to the back, black people to the front. This was said repeatedly. And who's pushing it? Paul Joseph Watson has another article. Hillary strategists blame stupid white people for popularity of Trump. Stupid white people are the worst. This is a white guy. Mitch Stewart. Again, race pimping. This is like a Klan leader. He's using race to control. Unbelievable racist. And it's always been that way. Look, the Republicans, the party of Lincoln passed the Civil Rights Act, and there was a revolt by people, and the Democrats flipped back over and said, okay, we're now the party against racism. I mean, and no one has a memory. People have the memory of a goldfish. Bernie supporters, Black Lives Matter clash with police outside DNC. We have a video. Man threatens to sick DNC protesters on female Trump supporter. It's unbelievable. Just like the guys waving Mexican flags, beating up the white woman. Can you imagine if a bunch of white guys were beating up a Hispanic woman? I would expect Hispanic men to get angry about that and speak out. But you know what? White people don't speak out because we deserve all of this, supposedly, even though I've never done anything to anybody on a racially based issue. Meanwhile, Trump and Pence blast DNC speakers. Not one of them names ISIS. When we come back, I've got the new laundry list of Islamic attacks that are unbelievable. And they've got Islamists beating up two cops. The German cops are such social worker wimps. They lay down while this wimp beats them up. And the German police say they're going to go after whoever shows the video. Well, we're going to show the video. I'm going to say something right now that I guarantee you is extremely important and, quite frankly, very, very profound. And I want this to be a message to the globalists, to the social engineers, to the technocrats who have not learned from history and who think they're invincible. If they want to have the illusion of an elected government, they're going to actually have to at least let people vote in the primaries and pick the candidate of their choice. Then you can try to steal the general election and maybe get away with it. But you can't fix it early on in front of everyone and have it be common knowledge that it's been stolen and that a party system like the Communist Chinese Central Committee and Politburo is selecting the nominee. And that's indicative and is a bellwether of the old, rusty, quasi-royal political class of the Democrats and the Republicans trying to hold on by their fingernails with that weird, creepy Bill Clinton walking around on stage spewing lies. If I was going to cast someone for a horror movie where there's a funeral home and they're really all devil worshippers killing people or something, I mean, I would cast Bill Clinton. I mean, Bill Clinton is who I would cast as a pedophile. It's who I'd cast as a rapist. It's who I'd cast as a pervert, as a murderer, as a monster, as a psychopath, as a serial killer. I mean, that's who he is. All of it's true. That is a literal demon. And they cut to Hillary smiling, breaking the glass ceiling. And I look at the crowd supporting her. These are creepy, weird, dumb losers who all organize together so they can just run the government and rob everybody. The average Democrat knows they're a piece of criminal filth. And they hate those of us that are smart. And they hate those of us that are successful. Now, you've got a bunch of young women meaning well, buying into this whole thing, who think they're going to get ahead because the system has set it up to put women in positions of power. All these images of women crying they put up. And Hillary only up there with girls as they end the human condition, as they break up the family, put women in the positions of power in the final phase ahead of the technocracy and the robots replacing the general population. This is all the admitted plan. And you're watching women married to the state and that it's the man that's going to bring home the bacon by giving them the job. This is the greatest slavery I've ever seen. But here's what's profound and important. I guarantee you, unequivocally, I can just study history, I can see it, that rotting Hillary and rotting Bill and rotting Obama and hateful Michelle Obama and Michael Moore and all these people are just indicative of the death of the establishment. And it's not just happening here. It's happening all over the world. Populism's rising, and there's nothing they can do to put the genie back in the bottle. There's nothing you can do. You're not going to be able to control humanity. You're not going to be able to play us off against each other. Time is running out for you in a big, big way. If you were smart and actually put good candidates forward, at least new candidates, younger candidates, smarter candidates, candidates that had at least a little bit of populism and weren't out to get everybody, you would remain in control and power and could grow your technocracy and probably beat humanity in the end if you went a little bit slower. But you're so arrogant, you're so disconnected, you're so drugged up. You can look at Hillary and Bill, and I mean, the footage of her in public doing weird tics and quirks and looking like she's about to fall down and completely insane. This is the madness of King George. This is the madness of the Pharaoh. I forget the poet that said, or the historian that said, that when God wants to destroy us, he makes us mad. Those that God would destroy, he first makes mad. And I'm just telling you, steal the election from Trump. He's probably 10 points ahead, as best I can tell. Pull whatever scams you want. You people are evil. You stink spiritually. God sees you, and you'll always be maggots. There it is, the phrase, whom the gods would destroy, they would first make mad, taken from Prometheus. We'll be back. Stay with us. A assemblage of stunted gremlins. It would be what I have seen at the DNC. Watch C-SPAN. Look at the operatives. Look at the creepiness of them. When they even talk to each other, they're all scrabbling and backstabbing and hating each other. It is the most dishonorable, rotten group of people I've ever seen. And I've been to DNC events before and not picked up on something this slimy. You know, some of the crowds are well-meaning idiots, but when you talk about the operatives, the people working it, the useful idiots they're bringing up, I mean, this is a group of miscreants. We're getting Roger Stone hooked up right now with big breaking news. 28-hour broadcast is live. Coming up, Germany, Muslims threaten to exterminate nudist and sluts. Video, Muslim man angry at delayed flight beats up police at Frankfurt Airport. Police try to censor the fact that he's Muslim or that he beat the police up. Because they're such social workers, they just lay down to it. Very pathetic. Migrant molester, I hate Sweden, I'm just here to F Swedish girls. Infowars.com. Munich attack fallout, Germany prepares for domestically deployed military. Martial law to suppress Germans to continue the migrants. They admit this is to stop Germans. Boy, you talk about a plan. This is a plan. Welsh schoolgirl kept in a cage by her father for 4 years. She was taken from England and taken and put in a cage. But that's all right. Sharia law. It's all right. Huh? It's okay. Isn't that just cute? And then meanwhile, we have this little giblet of news. Judge frees Reagan shooter John Hinckley Jr. after 35 years in a mental institution. John Hinckley Jr.'s brother met with the Bushes in Colorado 2 days before the shooting. Best buddies with the Bushes and all hooked up with the Central Intelligence Agency. But Reagan survived. So that's just some of the news on that front. Meanwhile, what's happening inside the convention? Democratic platform calls for carbon tax. Oh, of $100 trillion every decade. Just what Davos called for 6 years ago. Meanwhile, Clinton war criminal, who said 500,000 Iraqi children is a good price to pay for security in the Gulf, which hasn't given us security, says Trump has destroyed U.S. foreign policy. And they blame him for ISIS. Did you know that? Because he called for the very strategy a year before the Russians deployed it that took ISIS out to a great extent. Of course, that's because he was being advised by General Flynn and others who had been secretly working with the Russians. Oh, countermanding in a soft coup against Obama, the plan to fund al-Qaeda and ISIS. And now General Flynn says Hillary should be arrested. It's not just Alex Jones saying that now. More voices are. Oh, Hillary says the Russians are so bad they hacked her stealing the election. And they also hacked the UN, hiding the decline in temperatures and pushing carbon tax. And Putin said, we've exposed it because it's a plan to dehumanize populations and lower the population in bankrupt nation states. So I say, I salute the Russians. We have a foreign globalist group running our country. We're talking about that with Roger Stone. And so thank God we've got people in the Pentagon, people like Trump and people like Vladimir Putin and others who are trying to stop the plan that will kill billions in the first decade if they turn the carbon off. This is the plan. The 21st century, they kill you by turning the energy off. It's called siege. They used to do it a long time ago. This is high-tech siege. Learn about it. We have their emails. We have the enemy plan. This is not our opinion. We warned you of civil war and the plan to start a war with the police. We know what we're talking about. And yes, it's just free humans across the world are fighting back, and we've only begun to fight. Video, Dem rep accuses Trump of cashing in on 9/11. Yeah, see? Everything he didn't do, they say he did. Bill Clinton's love story speech missed out of all of his sex scandals. Susan Sarandon leaves, says, worst time, I'm out because they stole the election. Well, good for her. It's all coming up. Now, before we go to Roger Stone, who I think we've almost got him, correct? Good. Before we go any further, during the 28-hour broadcast, obviously, we are just doing one more thing to help fundraise to be able to continue at the level we're at and hopefully get a few more camera people, a few more reporters, a few more writers, a few more editors. Because quite frankly, we got a lot of people with black circles around their eyes around here. We got a lot of folks been working 18 hours a day for about 2 weeks, like Rob Dew, who I've just had to tell he needs to settle down a little bit. He hadn't seen his family in 2 weeks when he got back yesterday. He was still working, and I said, look, you need to go on home and see your family. He flew in at 5 a.m. from Philadelphia, and I said, he said, yeah, he went and saw his kids. He's back this morning. All I'm telling you is trying to get good people, organizing them is hard enough, then having the money to pay them a decent living wage. So we are the tip of the spear. We are information warfare kamikazes. Everybody knows it. You see how we are dominating the narrative because it's the truth. The truth always trumps a lie, folks. You can't suppress it forever. When it finally explodes, it's unstoppable. To quote Victor Hugo again, no army can stop an idea whose time has come. And so, the number one thing you can do is spread the link to Infowars.com/giant, Infowars.com/show, on your email list, Facebook, Twitter, the next 28 hours to get millions and millions of new people tuning in, not just the millions that are listening right now. If you're listening on AM and FM stations, call your friends, call your neighbors, tell your employees when they go to lunch, listen. This is how we have excitement. It's how we grow the movement. Look at how we're starting to win. If people realize that we have history on our side, we're unstoppable. So let me just read to you what's happening with Operation Sleeping Giant. That's now live. We're 40 minutes into it. 28-hour broadcast. The Operation Sleeping Giant Super Sale fundraiser is now live. The Operation Sleeping Giant Super Sale fundraiser is live at InfoWarsStore.com. You're listening to a historic 28-hour broadcast taking place live during Queen Hillary's coronation at the DNC. Hillary Clinton has stolen a Democratic nomination from Bernie Sanders, and the globalists are now preparing to make their biggest move yet. I mean, I can't believe I'm reading this, and it's true. It sounds so sensational. And we're here to not just act like it's normal and all be zombies. We're here to say this is wrong and ring the alarm bell and break the trance, break the spell. And the spell's lifting. Everybody can feel it. With your choice of purchasing the high-quality products or making a donation on InfoWarsStore.com, you're helping us push back the globalist takeover. Oh, yeah, we're getting results. Get these unprecedented specials at InfoWarsStore.com right now for the launch of the Operation Sleeping Giant Super Sale Fundraiser. 40% off Brain Force. Never done that. It's indicative of waking up. Natural nootropics, amazing, cutting edge, 5-star reviews on third-party sites, already super low price, 40% off. I'm telling you, it's a loss leader. 20% off all ProPure water filters, giant. 30% off all Survival Shield X2. That's 30%, huge. 30% off all Super Male and Super Female Vitality. That's gigantic because it's the giant, Sleeping Giant Awakening. And the Sleeping Giant Ho, ho, ho. Destroy the tyranny giant. We need the funding. 20% off all survival seed packages with a widest selection. 20% off all t-shirts, including the Hillary rape shirt that's now going viral. 30% off Liver Shield and many more at InfoWarsStore.com. You've seen how far InfoWars has come over the past decade, and you've seen how effective we've been against the New World Order system. Now is the time to support InfoWars in this historic fight. Visit InfoWarsStore.com and be part of the Operation Sleeping Giant Super Sale Fundraiser Marathon broadcast. And folks, I tell you every year we're going to the next level, and you see exponential growth. I mean, right now we are on the level playing field with the enemy, thousands of articles admitting, from Newsweek to the New York Times, Alex Jones is the spirit of the movement against the New World Order. I mean, it's not a secret. I said, is this off record? And I was like, no, not really off record. But I mean, that's not just me saying that or the enemy saying that. Donald Trump knows that. So we're going to Roger Stone, who's now joining us, the hardest working guy out there. Guy works like 20 hours a day. It's insane. And he's got so much to cover. So I want to give him the floor on AGs going after investigations of Clinton's. This is, you're hearing this here first. How they try to plan to steal it, how Trump's going to fight back. So many angles. I want to just give him the floor now. Roger Stone, former head of Trump's campaign, obviously one of the prime movers out there exposing what's happening. Roger, thank you for joining us. You've got the floor. Take over.
Oh, it's great to be back with you. In all honesty, with Donald Trump pulling ahead in the polls, as I think I told you he would, we went out and we had a few too many of these last night. So I'm a little more late rising than I normally am. I'm very excited because the two things are happening here, Alex. Trump is gaining and Hillary is imploding, bombshell after bombshell. When presumably Russian hackers or Putin himself arranges for the truth to get to the American people, the Clintons attack the source rather than the content. It, of course, makes the contents no less true, and they expose the theft of democracy and the humping of Bernie Sanders. They expose that Deborah Wasserman Schultz is a mole. She's the mole who stole the nomination for Hillary. So, and then on the heels of that, Alex, the IRS has opened a national investigation. Banner line piece today in the Daily Caller. I can now reveal that the Ohio Attorney General has opened a formal investigation. This is, I think, maybe on the InfoWars website. Remember that any place the Clinton Foundation did fundraising, which is to say all 50 states, they're regulated by the state attorney generals. The problem with that is their state filings, like their federal filings, are permeated with fraud, partial information, some cases no information, some cases lies. We also know now that the IRS is looking specifically on epic skimming, meaning, for example, the nation of Norway says that they gave the Clinton Foundation X, but they only deposited Y. There's a number of these discrepancies involving government payments to the Clintons, which I think we recognize are bribes, but that are required to have disclosure in those countries. So this is somebody is skimming off the top. Who could that be but Bill and Hillary?
What did you make of the display last night? I mean, it looked like archetypal death. Clinton and all the tottering around and the politicos just look like a group of criminals.
Pardon me for getting distracted by the rakish tilt of my hat. It was the raping of democracy. The Clintons are having the worst run of luck I have seen. If Bill thinks so highly of Hillary, why did he cheat on her with thousands and thousands of women? Now, as a libertine, I'm not really concerned with Bill Clinton's consensual sexual affairs. My problem is not marital infidelity or adultery or girlfriends or mistresses or consensual sex. But as I've written in the Clinton's War on Women, which you can get at InfoWars.com at the store, the issue here is sexual assault and rape. It's bullying and violence against women. And Bill has perpetrated it. As you know, Hillary has covered it up by bullying Bill's victims.
Roger. Obviously, Trump is surging ahead. The fact that so many Bernie people, almost all of them we talked to now, say they're going for Trump. This has really got to be scaring Hillary. What do you expect her to strike back with?
Increasing attempts at censorship. I believe that the FEC and the FCC are harassing certain conservative news outlets over bogus complaints filed by David Brock that because you are pro-Trump, this constitutes some kind of corporate illegal contribution. It pretty much vacated by Citizens United. These are bogus complaints meant to harass news outlets into not covering, you know, certain people. They're going to continue to play these kinds of games at censorship. Did you notice how there was not a single American flag in the hall on the first night of their convention? Not one. Where's the stars and stripes? These people hate America. They apologize for America. Donald Trump wants to reassert American power.
And that's not just rhetoric. Let's talk about that. But then you know them. Who are these modern Democrats? Because they seem like mental patients. I mean, they already run the country. Why do they want to wreck it?
Well, because they're driven by what the tune that's been paid for by their funders. Hillary is a neocon. She's right over there with George W. Bush. The reason that the Russians are probably leaking this damning information is because they don't want a nuclear war either. Hillary's bent on a war that benefits her donors and the multinational corporations and the defense contractors that have already funded her assault on the White House. And Putin understands that. Putin, I think, sees in Trump a tough guy that he could make a peace deal with and both sides could live together. Is that not what we want? I think that's what we want.
No, instead, the globalists want to be underhanded and bring in global crisis. You can't do that with nuclear weapons now. Don't they understand? They can't pull a Napoleon or a Hitler today because it'll end the world.
Yeah, but this is the power game that I think that they are playing. And the establishment, including the international community, is hysterical about the rise of Trump. The rise of national.
And by the way, you're not just saying that. The Washington Post admitted, so did Bloomberg, that in the last week, top globalists, including the Chinese, have all been meeting and quote, how to, quote, double down and defeat the rise of populism. They admit world government's in trouble. So Trump and this whole movement has forced a global debate. Look at Brexit. This is incredible. Let's talk about that. And let's talk about the real polling numbers that you guys are getting, that you're researching, and really how far ahead Trump is and what you see in the last few months of this race. How will the empire strike back? I'm worried about false flags. I'm worried about an assassination attempt on Hillary, blamed on a patriot.
Well, when I was in Cleveland, I had an opportunity to meet with Nigel Farage. I understand that you met with him also. And then we saw him briefly there I guess it was a bar. And he was very focused on the enormous success they had with blue-collar labor voters on Brexit. There's a lot there to be learned. See, I think that the hardworking working-class Democrat, the people that pay their taxes, they don't go to demonstrations.
Hold on, we're going to skip this break. Go ahead.
That they're not rioting. They love their country. They love their flag. Their children are in the service, their grandchildren in the service. These people are fed up. And I think they exit the party, which is left today as a party of limousine liberals, crazy whack job progressives, the professional democratic gay establishment, which is not a gay establishment in America, I'm happy to say. Because I think Donald Trump is going to do extremely well among gay and lesbian voters because he's the only candidate who stands between them and Islamic terrorist immolation, like black people, like Hispanics, like whites. We are all subject to this. First they kill the gays, then they kill the Christians.
Separate from statistically being killed by a jihadi, why wouldn't the Democrats stand against that? Why are they for Islam and radical forms of it? that is the opposite of being liberal. It's the opposite of Thomas Jefferson.
Well, because the muscular Democratic foreign policy of guys like John Kennedy and Harry Truman, who we may have our criticisms of, but they were strongly anti-communist. Now, in the case of Truman, he broke the back of the communists in Greece when they tried to take over. Kennedy, I think, botched the Bay of Pigs, probably should never have approved the lame brain plan of the Bay of Pigs. But remember, Alex, he got elected president by running as an anti-communist hawk to Nixon's right. So that stream of patriotic Democrat that loved America.
And he cut taxes by 50%.
They don't exist anymore. The Democratic Party is a conglomeration of whacked out extremists. They're the extreme. We're the mainstream.
Yeah, they keep calling us extreme because we want private property and lower taxes, and they spend all day trying to make us look weird when they are the freak show with Black Lives Matter on the stage. Nothing about all the dead police. I mean, they could have had Black Lives Matter family members and then the widows of dead cops and everybody hug. That would have been better for the Democrats, but they don't. But see, they hate the country so much, they've got to create the division.
Yeah, and no American flags.
Why would you not have American flags? It's just like, right. It's the symbol of America's gone. We're the third world party now.
And they feature a long speech by the one woman we call Pocahontas, the woman who falsely claimed to be a Native American so that she could get certain preferences at Harvard. So, Alex, that was the most boring speech I've ever heard. I almost rather watch hate drives.
I was about to say, no energy. The Democrats look completely dead. So read us the tea leaves in the last 6-7 minutes. Give us other key things that are happening, Roger, because I mean, this is key.
Well, what's amazing is the way Trump is breaking out of the old model. You see, I think previously we thought of this based on the strategy being pursued by Hillary, which is the Obama strategy, which is not the Bill Clinton strategy. Get everyone on the left you can to vote for you. Register as many extras as you can. Some places try to vote illegals. That story will break. Conversely, that would make our strategy maximize every vote on the right and the center right. And the bet by the Clintons is that their stack is higher than ours. This is a strategy that worked for Barack Obama. Here's the folly in their argument. Trump can make incursions into small but key parts of their constituency. The people, the Clintons' policies are leaving behind. She has people voting for her whose interests she is betraying every day.
You know, I was just putting a Daily Caller article up on screen for TV viewers, and it shows the RNC with American flags everywhere, and then it shows the DNC, no American flags. Looks like some high-tech communist Star Trek meeting. You have to understand, these are globalists. They are ending national sovereignty. They are destroying the nation state and bringing in unelected tyranny. I mean, the choice could not be clearer. I'm all for bringing immigrants in. They're great people. We need them. But make sure they're not felons and have them say, we want to be Americans. We want private property and self-defense and wealth. Okay, if you don't want that, we're not letting you in. You have to pledge allegiance. You have to say you're in the club. And I just can't believe they're trying to bring people in who don't want to be part of the club, or they're trying to indoctrinate them to be in this sick anti-freedom club. It is crazy.
I apologize. We had some internet issues there and a little electrical outage. So
I understand. I can hear you. But what other key points do we need to know, Roger?
Well, the polls show that Trump, therefore, is making these inroads in places like Western Pennsylvania, parts of Ohio. There's New York, upstate New York. New York could actually be in play. He's doing extraordinarily well in New Jersey, Michigan, showing growing strength.
Isn't he going to win New York?
Well, I think New York is the bluest state in the country. I mean, registration, the Republican Party in New York City is down to about 19%.
But there's got to be some pride there. What about Florida? He's going to dominate Florida?
It's not a pride question. The Bushes and the Pataki's, the liberal Republicans, let the party go to shit. They have no fundraising base. They can't find candidates. They don't run anybody for the city offices. They leave candidates on the state ticket empty. It's pathetic. So Trump is bigger than the Republican Party. And he's got a lot of sizzle in his home state. And my guess is in the end, he'll fight for it. But all I'm saying is it is so Democratic, it's uphill.
But he's doing really good in Florida. What about Pennsylvania?
Florida, he's actually ahead. Pennsylvania, you see, I think I've always considered the fool's gold of a presidential politics. Bush did well there early, faded. Romney did well there, not Romney, McCain did well there early, faded. Romney did well there early, faded. A lot of money was spent on that state to lose. These are turd blossoms decisions, mostly. And they always fell short. What's interesting, though, is if you go back and look at why they were briefly ahead and why Trump's ahead today, they're not the same kind of voters. In other words, they're Democrats, union people, middle class, working people, overwhelmingly white. We're really eroding the Pittsburgh area and the Pittsburgh suburbs. Trump is running as like a typical Republican in the weaker eastern part of the state. The whole dynamic of Pennsylvania is problematic because you will lose the city of Philadelphia by 300.
Sure, I understand. So you're saying probably can't win it. What about California?
Well, let's finish it. You'll win by 350,000 votes, lose in the city. You'll make up a little bit in the suburbs. If you pick up the rest in the West, Trump's in play in the Keystone State. So I think it's great news.
Roger, we got you on late. I know you probably got another interview coming up. If you can't, that's fine. Pop in tomorrow. Or can you hold for 70 seconds, do 5 more minutes to finish up California and other states?
I would be delighted. I was late.
All right. You're awesome. StoneZone.com is his website. We carry both of his books. And we are doing this huge mega sale, 40% off Brain Force, 30% off a bunch of other items. It's a fundraising to help take the InfoWar to the next level. And you get great products at the same time. InfoWarsStore.com. Back in 70 seconds. 1 hour down, 27 hours of live broadcast to go. And I'll be here off and on throughout the 28 hours. I'll be here this evening, in the early morning, you name it, and right through the 4 hours tomorrow. We have a lot of amazing guests, everybody from Billy Corgan of Smashing Pumpkins to other surprise guests joining us. You definitely want to spread this link to everyone. This is weaponized media. Roger Stone, we got 4.5 minutes left, finishing up with the different states, how you see things going. And I know you told me a few weeks ago you think you'd be 5-6 points ahead by the end of the convention. Hillary, I think, is having a lackluster convention. Even mainstream media admits that, the scandal, the emails. I think she's mortally wounded. My gut tells me if they don't try to steal the election, they fail.
Well, Alex, first of all, I wanted to say I got this hat in preparation for going to Philadelphia. I mail ordered a Che Guevara T-shirt. I stopped bathing like the Friday before, and I was going to be out there with the demonstrators. And then it occurred to me that there was no reason to go. As I think it was Wellington said, never interfere with your enemy when they're in the process of destroying it themselves.
Exactly.
So, I did.
We both said that the last day in Cleveland on Friday, as we were saying bye, and then at like 2 a.m., we're like, oh, yeah, no, this is too good. We don't want to go there and look like, you know, we're stirring stuff up now.
They would falsely accuse us of inciting violence, like when we were set up by that fat Turk whose name I can't recall the other day in Cleveland. So, anyway.
But that little fat Turk got his butt handed to him.
in any event. Trump is really on his game here. And you always have to look at both ends of the race. By that, I mean Hillary's imploding between the IRS investigation, which is enormous. And I predict that before long, you'll have a half a dozen attorney generals in hot pursuit. You'll have Bill dodging subpoenas while he tries to campaign for Hillary. They have enormous, enormous problems.
Okay, other states, finishing up real quick. California, other states, how do you see this going?
Well, California is probably out of reach for the Republicans, in all honesty. However, Trump has a celebrity quality like Schwarzenegger that kind of transcends the old rules. There is no state in the country who is more celebrity conscious. I mean, Alex, I'd like to do a tour of California with you. Man, you'd rip the roof off. Californians are always ahead of the curve on pop culture. So I think Trump is a larger-than-life figure. Therefore, he reaches beyond conservative Republicans. Latinos, he has to make some inroads. But I'll tell you this. I know a lot of Hispanic Americans. You know what they want? Jobs.
I was about to say, California is falling apart.
Well, Jerry Brown is left holding a bag of shit. I mean, 100 years of liberal policies has borrowed and taxed them into the Stone Age. The state, he's had to make great economies. The state is a basket case. And it's much better than many other states. It's just overwhelmingly, though, Alex, it's become more Democratic. Demographically, it's not the state that Ronald Reagan won twice. Far fewer white voters, far fewer Republicans. There are riper targets, in my opinion.
Okay, what are the key targets? Where are the key battlegrounds that give the victory to Trump? Because he's ahead in all the polls.
Florida is key. Ohio will be key. Michigan will be key. Colorado will be key. Iowa will be key. This is why I have been saying that it is essential that 1 million new voters be identified through a sophisticated analytics program. These people are highly motivated. They're Trump voters. Go out and register. I would say do an analysis of how many votes Mitt Romney lost, let's say, Pennsylvania by. Double that number. Let's call it for the sake of discussion.
Roger, we're out of time. StoneZone.com. We look forward to speaking to you again soon. Get some rest, my friend. I've been working really hard. And sorry about your dog passing, my friend.
Anything.
All right. We'll be back with a ton of news, your phone calls, Leanne McAdoo, and our reporters on the ground from Philadelphia straight ahead. We have unprecedented jihad attacks exploding all over Europe, all over the UK, small children being grabbed and put in cages, just insanity. Nothing about it in our media. Western media trying to remove the names. When the first name's Ollie, they change it to David. We have entered a 1984 system, but it hasn't totally taken over. It's like the 1984 system's here operating in total disinformation, total evil, next to what's left of the old republic. And it's not that the old republic was perfect, but compared to what they're trying to replace it with, oh my gosh, this is so obvious. We're in the middle of a globalist revolution against this country. We have these war criminals giving speeches. We've got Donald Trump's speech coming up, and I'll play some excerpts of when he gave a press conference this morning. Very, very powerful. He talked about the criminal Hillary not having a press conference in 235 days, hiding with all of her activities. This is an epic time. This is a referendum on do we return to nationalism and open free societies or globalism based on racial and religious divisions. So it is all coming up today, ladies and gentlemen. We have a 28-hour broadcast. We are now 26 hours and 50 minutes into this, or we're now an hour and 9 minutes in, so we've still got 26-plus hours left in the global transmission. Infowars.com/giant to find the free video feed, audio feeds, backup YouTube feed, and it's so important in the InfoWar that everyone get that link. And send it to local talk stations. Send it to their pastor. Send it to their neighbor. Show it to their employees. Show it to your boss. Spread the word. If you're listening on local AM and FM or TV stations and cable stations, a lot of which are carrying it, thank them for carrying it. And also spread the word that the show is on. And many stations are deciding, I've been told, as this happened the last few years, to carry more of the broadcast later in the evening. We're also fundraising today. And we are doing sales, and I keep saying biggest ever, because we're getting to be the discount store, not just high quality, but high quality that's discounted. Because, I mean, I'd rather sell, 100 cheeseburgers at a lower price and end up being able to get more money to fund ourselves than sell 50 cheeseburgers at a higher price, but, make less money. It's that metric. We have a big enough audience to do that, so we're so competitive. Normally $29.95 for the nutraceuticals that are in Brain Force, which is emblematic of the Sleeping Giant Awakening, an incredible product. Try it for yourself. These compounds are so good for your brain. It just blows away the competition. 5-star reviews on third-party sites. 40% off. Normally $29.95. It's now $17.76. That's a little over 40% off, but we just say 40 because that makes like 40 point something. But $17.76 is how much it is right now. Free shipping on orders $50 or more. Sign up for AutoShip, additional 10% off. You'll get it at cost with AutoShip. We got 20% off all ProPure water filters. Already the best system out there. Already super competitive pricing. Gravity fed. Use it anywhere. 30% off all the Survival Shield X2, that's huge. 30% off super male and female vitality. 20% off all survival seed vaults with the widest selection. 20% off all shirts like the Made in America, Come and Take It, or the Hillary for Prison. 30% off Liver Shield and many other products at InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsLife.com. And this is just part of one more way we raise the capital to not just stay at the level we are. We've got to get probably 6, 7, 8 more people and have the money to have our crew go out and cover things. And we're dominating coverage. We're changing the global narrative. We're having the biggest effect, quite frankly, of anybody out there, thanks to all of our folks that are helping us, like DrudgeReport.com and others. But you are the key. The listeners that spread the links, that send out the podcast, that send out the video links, you are the key to all of us. I want to thank you and salute you. It is so humbling when I go out to Cleveland and other areas to shake your hand. And it felt so good to be there at those rallies where you'd have a third of the people being Black Americans and probably 20-30% being Hispanic. I mean, I'm telling you, there were less white people when you counted the quote minorities. We're all just human beings, and we want lower taxes. We want a Second Amendment. We know the globalists are eugenicists, heating hospitals around the world with dead babies and selling their body parts. Now, Leanne McAdoo is just popping in because she's going to be hosting a lot today. Then I'm going to go to David Knight, then to your phone calls at the bottom of the hour on everything that's happening, the epic state of the world, what's happening with Black Lives Matter, these Black Lives Matter groups getting up and saying, no whites at the front of the line, whites to the back. These videos are on InfoWars.com. Black and Hispanic Americans being shot and attacked if they tell people they support Trump. The weaponization of the media. 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. And we're now over an hour and 14 minutes in the 28-hour broadcast. I cannot tell you how critical it is to spread that link. Leanne McAdoo, drug you in here as you were back there doing research. You were making some really great points and actually pounding your hand on the on the door angrily. I rarely see this angry. It's good to see this energy. I mean, you always have great energy, but wow, watching the DNC last night, you know, David Knight's inside of it. We're about to go to him in that collectivist rat nest.
The Viper's den, yeah.
I mean, why are you so fired up?
Well, you know, I just... coming off what you just said, how incredible it was to be out there in Cleveland at the RNC and to see people from all backgrounds there just supporting us, supporting liberty. And then you go and look at what's happening at the DNC, where they are actually fighting, trying to bang through the gate there. Let us in. You rigged the system, you know. And all the media was out there at the RNC just looking for whatever kind of little protest they could to like jack it up and say, look,
even the Democrats' own minions are coming after them because even they know that's the power structure.
Yeah. I mean, and it's just like now that you actually have these people out trying to break this fence.
We have video of them climbing it.
Yeah. No, climbing it, setting flags on fire, like tons of flags, pushing police, violently pushing the police back, jumping on their cop cars. You don't see that. The media was like all either they were afraid, they were inside, afraid of the monster that they had been coddling and creating for the last couple of years, or they just want to, at the DNC.
That's right, Frankenstein is on the loose.
Right. Well, and the DNC is really pushing this narrative that America's already great. Why was Trump being so dystopic? America's already great. Totally ignoring the fact that it's like a war zone right outside.
And with even cooked numbers, 1.8 growth. Folks, we've been in a depression for a long time. It's just not equally distributed. We're going to come back to you, Leanne, and make more of the points you were talking about, Madeleine Albright. This what'd you call them, a parade of criminals?
Yes, it was the party of crooks. They stood true to who they are. I mean, it was like a whole criminal lineup last night.
David Knight, I know you're chomping at the bit, my friend. You've been inside that nest since Sunday. You know, this is like day three for you. What are your observations?
David Knight in Philadelphia, the Democrat National Convention. Alex, yesterday we were there as they were doing the roll call vote because we wanted to see the reaction of the Bernie supporters as the votes were being called out. And one of the places that they were focused on, of course, is California. They knew there was a lot of opposition there. The DNC had strategized beforehand they would have a lot of Hillary supporters right next to the loud and boisterous Bernie supporters, which they did. So you saw essentially two high school teams cheering very loudly against each other as that was going through. And then you had the massive walkout of the really hardcore Bernie supporters as that was going through. Now, we tried to get down to those guys. We missed most of them. We did talk to some of the people who were not as upset about it. They thought they could find some common ground with Hillary. And if you say that report that I put out with a couple of delegates from New York, it was absolutely, in my mind, totally delusional. they understand, as I point out to them, you know, Bernie has been authentic on these issues for decades, just as Trump has been authentic on trade and other issues. Yet Hillary has been on the other side of these issues that they say are vital to them, banks, as well as the trade agreements. And they said, well, we think that we're going to be able to convince her. And I said, no, she has tens of millions, hundreds of millions of reasons not to listen to you. And they said, well, we have millions of reasons as well. So what they think they're going to do, Alex, is they think they're going to go out and have demonstrations and protests, and that's going to bend Hillary Clinton to their will.
Yeah, because that stopped her stealing the nomination. She's going to go for broke, bringing us into the world government.
That's right. That's right. And, you know, I think it's interesting, Alex, to see how the media is taking the mask off. You know, we had this morning, Joe Biden went on Morning Joe with Joe Scarborough, a former GOP congressman. They gave Joe Biden a 30-second standing ovation. Can you imagine that on a television show? 30 seconds, and the journalists are giving them a standing ovation.
Even state-run media in China acts like they're not state-run and doesn't do that crap.
Exactly. But I see that, Alex, as a positive sign. You know, we reported about this in the bleachers on the first night as they were handing out all the different posters for each individual speaker to the press seating area, and the press was eagerly gobbling this up and waving their signs and cheering as the individual speakers came up. And you look at it and it's like, okay, fine, the mask is off. If we lose this pretense of being completely neutral and objective, I think that's, in the long run, a positive thing. They can't maintain that
pretense. I agree. This is a victory. Populism is rising. Even if they steal this, they're in deep trouble. So folks shouldn't get disheartened. But listen, Stone doesn't want to go too far and make people feel overconfident. But the truth is, internal polling across the board, and this isn't from Stone, this is from other folks, is showing big leads. He's 7, 8, 9, 10 points. It's getting wider. Florida is landsliding for him. Some think California's even in play, because if 30, 40% of the Bernie people go for Trump, it's game over. And so we need to target the Bernie people like never before and say, listen, you've been totally screwed. Don't be morons here.
They're calling you ridiculous. They're saying, okay, you're being ridiculous now, thinking you're going to turn this thing.
And they're confiscating their signs and beating them up.
Right, and they might not even be getting access now. From what I was looking at Twitter, that they took their credentials away. So maybe they're not even going to get back in there after their little protest stunt.
David, we're going to break. But I want to ask you this when we come back. In your gut, what do you think they're going to do? I mean, if Hillary stole, I want to ask you this too, Leanne. If Hillary stole the nomination in broad daylight, naked, I mean, this is like robbing, you know, a bank in slow motion in front of everybody at the World's Fair. Okay, I mean, she's in front of God and everybody doing this. What's to keep her from everything else? So when we come back, we're going to talk about that. And we're also going to talk about other shoes to drop. What other emails the Russians or whoever the fairy godmother is that are releasing these are going to do that. Leanne McAdoo, David Knight in studio with me. Your phone calls are coming up at 800-259-9231. It's part of Operation Sleeping Giant. We're now into hour number two of 28 hours of live global transmission that ends tomorrow at 3 p.m. Central Standard Time. Spread that link, Infowars.com/giant.
Americanism, not globalism, will be our credo.
The era of economic surrender will finally be over.
We will no longer surrender this country or its people to the false song of globalism.
Turd Blossom, I am a friend. You know that, right?
Don't touch me again. Do not touch me again. Do you understand?
Chairman Friendly.
Do not touch me again.
Well, sure, I want
to. You do that, you're in trouble.
Any country that tries to be free, these globalists come in and they cause a bunch of division and they stir up a bunch of racism and they get everybody fighting with each other. But you know what? It ain't working. All this garbage has brought America together.
Listening to their grievances, I'm trying to figure out who they are, what they're with. Very hostile, very profane group. And just got cussed out for just wanting to ask them a simple question, what they're doing here.
I'm not retiring. You know, I'm not going to go and sit and, as I say, up in the hills and smoke a pipe all day, no.
Are you worried that the globalists are going to try to hijack this Brexit?
They can try if they want to, but it won't work. Those people who made their minds up to vote for Brexit, despite all the threats that they were getting from the international community, the political, I mean, good to be, the US president even came to London to tell them what they should do. And they made their minds up. They struck out. They voted for freedom. That's what they voted for. If they don't get it, if they're betrayed, then you'll see even bigger political shocks than we saw with the Brexit result.
They don't rule us because they're strong. They rule us because they're scum and because good people don't think like they do. Well, I'm here to tell you, I've studied the enemy and so have our guests, and we are here educating people about how our enemy operates. And they're going to find out who's strong, and they're beginning to find out who's strong right now.
The hate of Hillary, blaming cops, and killing cops is not the way. That's right, absolutely. That's right. The communists want to kill cops. We're not putting up with it. We're not going along with it. We understand the violence of the left, the violence of the globalists. We are here absolutely exposing it, and we're not going to back off, and we're not going to stop. We are here to expose what's happening.
Getting a little chaotic out here. So Rob Dew reporting for Infowars.com. It is getting chaotic.
I'm a black man. I come from Amityville, Long Island. I took the bus ride because let me tell everybody something. We have been hijacked. We've been hijacked. And I love Alex Jones. And I'm here for Donald J. Trump. It's not about color. It's about the powers that be who are separating us. Divide and conquer. Divide and conquer. That's what they always do.
Hillary for prison. 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 Hillary for prison.
Welcome back to continued live coverage of the coronation of Queen Hillary. Can't believe I'm just here calmly talking about her openly stealing the nomination. They tried it with Donald Trump and it failed. That really tells you something about where the real insurrection is. It's in the Republican Party, as I've been saying for years. The Democrat Republicans have been caught on tape with the Clintons meeting, Obama meeting, with the Republicans saying, we got to combine forces with the National Chamber of Commerce that helps ship our jobs overseas and the Republican establishment and the Democrats to block a populist insurrection in the Republican Party, the Tea Party. And I see footage that we were just airing during the break, because a lot of our breaks are just actually information, not just ads, of our crew in Philadelphia. And I'm talking a large percentage of people are Hispanic and black and Asian, and they're just having a great time with all these evil white people talking about free market and freedom and absolutely articulating real issues. They've done everything they can to say the Tea Party's racist so that minorities don't feel like they have a place at the table. It's a total hoax, and I see the hoax under Trump collapsing. Because the truth is, he's always been inclusive. The guy 30 years ago got criticized by conservatives because he was inclusive of gays and was an advocate for people to have equal rights. The truth is, Trump's a great guy, and that's why they hate his guts. Leanne McAdoo, then back to David Knight.
Well, yeah, I actually got in a fight with one of my friends just trying to explain how Trump was one of the first people that opened up his golf course decades ago and said, well, what the heck? Of course black people and minorities can join my private club. What do you mean? You know, but nobody wants to talk about that.
Yeah, the first golf courses he built, he did that, and it was just unheard of. I can't really believe that even goes on.
No, it still goes on. There are still clubs that do not allow minorities to join. I mean, that's a fact.
Gambling's illegal at Bushwood.
So, well, I just want to, you know, I don't know how long we want to go get into this.
But, well, we got more time in the next segment. I'll finish up. Go ahead.
Everyone just needs to take a look at what's going on at the DNC and just acknowledge that like attracts like. So here you have the RNC. People were peacefully protesting. There wasn't a lot of chaos, mayhem. Like you said, there was people just actually having conversations. But then you go to the DNC and you have people outside, complete mayhem. And on the inside, they have a complete criminal lineup trying to convince
everyone. And then we had communists come after us and try to block us. But we did, and it was, and the only violence we did have was the young T's, the young jihadis coming after us as well.
Well, I mean, talk about the media kind of showing its true colors. I mean, they're set up in the YouTube studios on the YouTube set.
Sure. So answer my questions. We'll come back and get into the other issues. I want to get David's take on this. Going back to David, what do they do? A false flag? An assassination attempt? Steal the election? I mean, what are they going to pull? It's clear that Hillary is collapsing with the narrative that she's a criminal, with the foundation and the emails and the new emails. And even Democrats are saying, oh, my God, she's super corrupt. I mean, I see her really collapsing right at her launch point.
Alex, the new R word is not racism, but Russian. They're trying to lay that on Donald Trump about these leaks. And, of course, the obvious thing is to distract from the content and say, well, who did this? You know, as we've seen that done all the time before with the NSA whistleblowers, with Ed Snowden, they don't want to talk about what was actually revealed about their criminal actions. Instead, they want to talk about who revealed it and make a criminal out of them. But, Alex, there's something that is far more dangerous and subtle about that. I think there is a subliminal message of propaganda pushing back against Donald Trump because, of course, his message has been America first. Either can
having a Skype problem there, I'm guessing you're going to say the truth is he's really a Russian agent. The truth is he doesn't want to go, you know, against foreign adversaries. No, the truth is the globalists are using us to take over countries when it hurts our interests and other interests. Globalism is bad. Go ahead.
Well, what they have seen here is that first night, and of course, they started using the Russian narrative before that, but, you know, they continue to use
it. Sure, so what's the subliminal?
Well, the subliminal is that they don't want people to see Donald Trump as being America first, as pro-American, mm-hmm. as patriotic, because the Democrats, that's their issue, right? That's their weakness. People understand that they don't want to put the American flags on their stage, and that's what we saw the other day. So what they do is they fight against Trump by saying, oh, look, he's on Russia's side. They're helping him. Well, she helped Russia.
Right.
She released our most secret documents to Russia in order to help herself because she had private secrets.
That's right. Thank God the Russians are releasing the carbon tax fraud. Thank God they're exposing the fact that this woman's a criminal and stole our election. I mean, that's shameful. The Russians have to do our media's job. I mean, we don't need the emails to know they stole it. She stole it in front of God and the world.
Right. If they are doing that, she's the one that allowed it.
It's
the Russians.
It pretty much is the Russians.
Well, whatever it is, Alex, you know, Julian Assange, who's with WikiLeaks, said, in his opinion, Trump was unpredictable, but he said Hillary Clinton is totally predictable and problematic. Mm-hmm. He says she is against free speech. She wants to shut down everything in terms of free speech, and she is a war hawk.
She's a war hawk.
And, of course, if you remember back at some of the other leaks that Wiki put out, Manning leaks, showing the way the war was being conducted, other issues in terms of the invasion of Libya and Hillary Clinton's State Department policy there. He's been exposing this kind of stuff, and WikiLeaks has been exposing it for quite some time.
That's right. So they know she's bad. We'll be right back. We'll finish up with David Knight and Leanne. Then your calls. The full schedule's up on Infowars.com/giant, and we're doing giant sales throughout this. It is a marathon broadcast super sale fundraiser. You can make donations on the shopping cart and on the site and at the website, Infowars.com/giant, if you want to give straight to the movement. Or you can just go get amazing products, whether it's Super Male Vitality or Female Vitality or Brain Force. It's 40% off. It's $17.76. That's actually more than 40% off, but we just say 40 because it's like 40 and some change. It's a loss leader sale. Brain Force has hundreds of independent five-star reviews. You really owe it to yourself to try it. The formula uses natural brain activation ingredients like L-theanine and alpha-GPC that you can feel. Some of the ingredients in Brain Force are prescription drugs in Europe. This is the real deal. Get Brain Force for $17.76, down from $29.95 at InfoWarsLife.com during the Operation Sleeping Giant Super Sale fundraiser before we sell out. And you can go read the five-star reviews here. Awesome product by Val in Lima, Peru. It's my second day, but I can say I do feel its power. Yesterday when I took two capsules, I felt the effects within an hour. It's strong and very effective. Yeah, don't give Rob Dew two of them.
I know.
He's a really sweet guy. So I mean, I'll be honest with you. If you're exhausted, you tell you're going to be awake, but it's we're not playing games here. Continuing, a feeling tired and groggy Patrick in an undisclosed location, five-star review, says, Rainforest is a game changer. You can actually feel the herbs working to clear your mind and put some pep in your step. I feel like I have a new, young, and healthy brain again. Not sure what the active ingredient is in this product, but I love it. Well, you can read the bottle. It's actually got compounds that are building blocks of the brain. It's got some great, clean, herbs that are known to clean and give you energy. It's got a little bit of green tea, too, that just helps supercharge the neurons. That's only an activator. You don't want to just activate neurons. You want to give the brain building blocks, is the way it's all described by Dr. Grip. All I know is, you know, even the nutraceutical Nazis, even the supplement Nazi sites love it. And they go, wow, there's similar formulas for like $80. And the industry says, Alex, everybody else marks it up 7 times. You mark your stuff up 50 to 100%. And I'm like, I mean, the average is 5 to 7 times. Our average is about 100%.
And we use much better quality.
Well, absolutely. I mean, you know, that's why this is such high quality. And people go, yeah, there's folks selling basically the same thing we're selling, close to it, for $75. And it's not even as good as our formula.
Right.
And it's just like, it's crazy. I mean, I wouldn't be having to do fundraisers, though, I guess, if I did, like, put some huge price tag. And everybody thinks it's like God. Like, this must not be good. It's $17.76.
Right.
Well, yeah, and it's like we're making like $3 on it. But you know, the point is, I want to sell 50,000 bottles, not 1,000 bottles. So that's going on InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com, or call toll-free if you want to just call and donate or call and ask questions or order the products. Huge discounts on hundreds of items, some of them as high as 40%. InfoWarsStore.com, free shipping on orders $50 or more. And we have 10% off additionally. That still holds anything you sign up for auto ship, like the non-GMO, super high quality, high mountain, Chiapas Mexican coffee. Personally, it's like Guatemalan coffee, but better. Totally organic, volcanic soil. Whether it's the, there's a lot of products that obviously you want to put on reorder, like the nutraceuticals and things. And again, I want to thank you all, because the success of InfoWars is your success. And I want to thank you, our AM and FM affiliates, our cable affiliates, our UHF, VHF affiliates. I want to thank the listeners. I want to thank God. I want to thank my mother for praying for me, my grandmother, who's 91 years old. I want to thank everybody for putting up with me. Sometimes it's a train wreck, including my crew. And I put up with them. But we're all one human family that has red blood fighting the technocrats that think we're animals. David Knight, I want to give you a few minutes to finish up and tell us what else you think is coming up. And then I want to go back with some final comments from Leanne and then go to some phone calls. But I've got to say, I'm not putting a pretty face on this, and I agree with you. And then I want to get your take on this, Leanne, the question, what will they pull to try to derail this? That's what everybody should be thinking right now. Get in the mind of your enemy. I think it was Lord Wellington that he was quoting earlier, Stone, don't ever interrupt your enemy while they're destroying themselves. It was Sun Tzu said, you have to get in the mind of your enemy. You have to think like your enemy. You have to be your enemy. And that's what I do. Napoleon Bonaparte also said, never interrupt your enemy when he's making a mistake. I think they both kind of said it back at each other, but it really goes back to Sun Tzu. If you read that little book, he said, if the enemy's already screwing up and things, kind of let him go for a while, you know, and see how long that plays out. Sometimes they might collapse without you even having to attack them.
Right.
So those are just some of the rules to that. But David, the worm has turned. Again, they can't put Humpty Dumpty back up there. They said to steal this out of their arrogance. They had to, you know, go in there and do this. And it's this tottering group that looks like they're reanimated corpses. You're in there personally. You have the useful idiot followers with, you know, the looks of dumb children in their eyes. I feel sorry for them, but when I see the party apparatchik and I see them talking to each other, it just radiates disingenuousness, just backstabbing, dishonor. It gives me the creeps.
Well, Alex, as we're talking to these different delegates that were for Bernie and they want to see the TPP stop, they understand what's going on with that. And as I pointed out to one guy, I said, you know what, you and I disagree on a lot of issues, but we're not going to be able to even have a voice in this in the future if we turn over our governance, our sovereignty, to foreign multinational corporations and a committee that's going to rule this and is going to be able to rewrite the rules. You know, Senator Sessions is the only one who read the TPP, and of course, he's been the advisor to Donald Trump since last August. He pointed out that the TPP and the rest of these trade, like the TTIP for one with Europe, these are living documents. They have provisions that allow these small committees to alter them, to include China, to include other nations at will. They can alter the terms of this to manage our economy, but also to manage many other aspects of our government here.
And again, we're just calmly talking about Europe and the U.S. being signed on to secret global treaties.
Yeah.
And then we're the extremists for talking about it. Go ahead.
Well, they understand that. And yet they think that they can have some influence on Hillary Clinton, who has been with this all of her life. And Wall Street is ecstatic about not only Hillary Clinton, but her VP pick, Kane. And so I think what they're going to see, Alex, what she will throw them as a bone, is she's going to talk a lot about gun control for the left. She's going to talk about some of these social issues, because those are some things that she can throw them as a bone. But the key fundamental issues that they're going to lose control of the country if they don't understand this is going to be the trade issues. You know, as they were going down this roll call yesterday, and as part of the state pride, you know, back in North Carolina, we've got these license tags that say first in flight, because we had the Wright brothers did their flight there at Kitty Hawk. So there's this Guinness Book aspect of the states as they're going, giving people a flavor of their states. But most of what they focused on with the Democrats was the first person of this color or this sex or whatever to do this or that, to get elected to this position. They're absolutely, totally out of touch with another real first. And that was the first time in our living memory, okay, for hundreds of years, since Islam was taken out of Europe for the first time after they invaded it, for the first time we had a priest executed by Muslims in a church. That was a first. And we've gone now 2 days without them talking about this issue. So I think it's going to be a real hard thing for them, Alex, if they try to do some kind of a false flag or to try to get a control of this, because they are already not seen as the people who are part of the solution. They're seen as the people who are bringing in the terrorists in massive numbers and bragging about it. We had John Kerry, the last day of Ramadan, talking about how he brought in six times more people from Syria.
And Hillary wants to accelerate it by five times. And just to add here, David, the point you make, listeners have to hear this. It's so central. This is so key. They're getting rid of achievement of having liberties, having freedoms, having private property, having free association, having free will. And now it's a collective, the first person of this or this person of that or this statistic on that, because they're taking innovation. They're taking prosperity. They're taking real rights away and giving us all these things the globalists don't care about. This is total and complete engineering. And then you look at the fruits of what the Democrats have delivered to their constituents. They're all, on average, worse off because the globalists want them dependent. This is a plan. It's not just that they're mismanaging. So I'm really concerned about false flags, assassination attempts, you name it. David Knight, 60 seconds, so we're going to go back to McAdoo, and you can continue with your great reporting.
Well, Alex, I think that, you know, when we look at what's happening again, we need to understand that what they're trying to do with this push with Russia is not only to avoid the dark secrets that have been exposed about their collusion and rigging of the electoral process or collusion with the media, but they also wanted to subtly push this idea that Trump isn't for America first. We know that that's the central issue, and I believe that he's authentic on it. The guy that I talked to was absolutely surprised when I told him that Donald Trump had been opposing NAFTA for 30-some odd years.
And the Iraq War.
He was taking out ads in the New York Times.
And the Iraq War. David Knight reporting from the DNC there in Philadelphia. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
All right, McAdoo, I want to get your final comments and let you go get ready, because I know you're doing a lot of research and helping the show. And just appreciate your amazing work you did there at the RNC. But just to add to what he's getting at here, I even got blindsided by this Islamic tidal wave. I mean, I don't support what radical Islam does. I don't support what dominant Islam does, Orthodox Islam. I mean, it's in a major radicalization phase that's taking over right now. I thought the elites would use the attackers to take our freedoms. No, they are really planning to bring in millions and millions more and make us submit to them, because that's just another form of authoritarianism. And then, like, it's some form of hospitality. We send all our kids to Islamic training. Germany's making it law now and put martial law on the streets. Germany's now announced that troops to stop Germans protesting. I mean, this is unprecedented. Since the fall of Hitler, there's been a German law that you can't have troops on the street policing the people. Duh. They're doing it and saying it's for the Germans. This is sick. High treason. Why would the elite of the West want to butcher this open, laissez-faire, libertine society that is true liberalism? I mean, as a true liberal, I find it horrifying. I mean, as someone that spoils my daughters, that has spoiled the women in my life, as someone that is all about true freedom, to be called a fascist, a racist, and then to watch our enemies cavort and align with the worst scum of the planet.
Right. Well, I mean, that's what we're seeing there, that they're the party of gaslighting. Okay, they have everyone completely convinced that they're the good guys. I mean, while they have a whole entire criminal lineup rolling out, telling you why you need to vote for Hillary, the most criminal candidate that's ever run. It's like when you catch your boyfriend cheating, right? And then he turns around and blames you for violating his privacy because you went into his phone. Like, how dare you? Oh, you know, it's like, no, you cheated on me, right? So they totally twist this game around, get everyone's minds all twisted, and they're the party of opposites. I mean, I just could.
Of mind control.
Total mind control, total opposites. And, you know, you say, well, how could they do this? How could they destroy liberty? It's just like in the movie The Hunger Games. They have the capital of Pan Am where all the elite, they're in there gorging themselves, loving everything. And meanwhile, out in the districts, it's all socialist, communist, people are suffering. But they don't care because they're living the high life. And that was exactly what it looked like inside.
And then they act like they're the communist up on the top with red carpets.
Right.
And then tell those of us producing we stole something. We're like, what? Right. I'm employing 50-something people, paying them well. What the hell are you doing, jackass?
Right, and they roll out like Mike Brown's mom from Ferguson, the moms of the movement. They have them speaking in the lineup last night. But meanwhile, all of the protesters and the people that they've activated out of Ferguson are outside trying to bang the gates down saying, let us in, you scumbags. So it's like, hey, wait, well, all the people that you say you represent are right outside. Why don't you go talk to them and see how they feel about you rigging the election?
And by the way, the Republicans, as you said, had the gates to get in 30 yards from the entrance.
Right.
They have this, Knight's telling me, almost 2 miles away. He says it's, with all the equipment, exhausting. He's almost 4 miles, because right. You know, the iPhone can tell you how far you've gone. It's almost 4 miles, he was saying to me.
Wow. Yeah, and that's the thing is we...
You got to go back and forth, 4 miles.
Right, and they shut down the shuttles that take people there because they were afraid that they were going to have protesters getting in.
And I guess they do, because we never got to the really dramatic footage of people climbing over.
Oh, climbing over, attacking the cop cars. I know Joe Biggs was right there in the thick of it, as usual. He pinned it to your profile last night, where they're just all over the cop cars. The cops are... I mean, it's at this point, it's like...
Yeah, go to Joe Biggs' Twitter, folks.
Who are you even protecting at this point? It's almost like you guys need to get back out and save yourselves because these protesters are...
Listen, if I was the cops, I'm going to be honest with you. If I was the police, because, I mean, the average cop I know, hardworking people put their lives on the line. Sometimes you run into a crazy, arrogant guy on a power trip, and the other cops hate them, okay? And it's those bad cops that give them a bad name. The police are given submissions that are unconstitutional or wrong. We're trying to reform that. But foreign global is trying to cause a civil war. We're not having any part of that. But I'll be honest with you. If you're not getting the backing and there's Black Lives Matter and the Democratic Party's inside and Black Lives Matter and the communists are trying to knock the fence down, if I was the cops, I'd just walk off.
Right.
I mean, quite frankly, because there's the people launching this horde against you. They're in there stealing stuff, diverting them off onto you. And I was just saying, go have at it, man.
Right. And they have the people who are the movement, right, on stage. They didn't have any family members of the fallen police officers speaking out last night. It wasn't about that at all. It was about catering to a certain group.
But if they'd have brought, imagine if they'd have had both groups together.
Right.
See, if I was a Democrat and really trying to bring people together, I would have the folks that had died wrongly or questionably and the police that had died wrongly and questionably, and I'd have them come together. That'd been genius.
How can we come together? But that's not what they're about. And then they've got Eric Holder, Madeleine Albright, and then, of course, Bill Clinton, who was the rotten cherry on top of the sundae of speakers there. But it's just the whole...
Did he not look like something out of a zombie movie?
I got to give David Knight a round of applause for even just... sitting through that entire, I had to shut it off.
People ask why I didn't go. I cannot be around Democrats.
It's just like,
and I can't have a bunch of pasty white people with, you know, racist folks jumping in my face, spitting at me, telling me I'm racist.
Right. Well, and that's the thing with the Black Lives Matter protests when they're like, all the white people get in the back. It's like the majority of the people there were white. You know, but
yeah, they're there to support the movement, and then you're spitting on them.
They don't want you there. They think you're scum, filth. They can't wait to rule over you and dominate you. It's not
the same mindset as the Ku Klux Klan. People are people, and you can have a bunch of dumb black racists, like a bunch of dumb white racists, and it's just the more ignorant people are, the more racist they are. I mean, it's a fact. And look, everything you're hearing is the opposite of Martin Luther King. I'm going to skip this break, too, because I want to get to Jason and Sean and Patrick and Chris and John. Last break, I'm skipping today. And then we're going to be into hour number 26 soon. I mean, 2 hours in with 26 hours left. This is a 28-hour live broadcast, Operation Sleeping Giant. And you can go to Infowars.com/giant to find the video feed. Because when this four-hour radio TV show ends, we're going to be basically commercial-free with a bunch of special guests and more right through until tomorrow when the show kicks back on again live. So it's going to be live until tomorrow at 3 p.m. Infowars.com/giant. Tell everybody to go there. Big live coverage of the dictatorship being set up with Queen Hillary. Infowars.com/giant. Now, I got to ask this question. I'm going to Jason and John and Chris and Sean and Patrick and everybody else. Leanne, what do you think they're going to pull? She's sliding in polls internally. The numbers are, in some swing states, she's up to 10 points Trump's up to 10 points ahead against Hillary. Things are degenerating quickly. They admit he's 5 to 10 points ahead already. What are they going to pull in your gut?
I hate to even be negative about this. I like to try to think positively about what I want to create in the world, but I've been saying this for months. I truly think if they lose the game here, they're going to do some sort of a false flag, and they're already setting up a boogeyman, Russia. And the media doesn't even question if there's no proof behind it. They're just like, oh yeah, they definitely, it was them. They hacked into it. They're the boogeyman. We've always been against them. Putin's this like mastermind who's just able to control things all over the globe, giving him all this credit, all this power. And no one's even questioning if that, you know, obviously I've talked to Margaret. She said they do actually have some really good hackers. So,
well, the point is that Russia has the will when our own government run by criminals is trying to overthrow their elections and trying to start a war. Russia's never got involved in modern times in our politics, but Russia knows we're run by globalists that have taken us over.
Right.
It's in their interest to let us know, hey, carbon taxes are to rip you off.
Right.
And thank God Russia did that. We'd have them right now.
Right. And Putin's coming out speaking in public right there on camera saying, Americans, your media is lying to you. They're telling you everything is safe out here and World War III is right at your doorstep thanks to your government. And it's the same thing. The DNC.
Absolutely. Russia has three bases. Russia is trying to stop collapsing.
Yeah.
Russia is trying to just survive. They're not a threat. Communist China is a threat because the globalists are allied with it. China and the globalists are the threat. China and the globalists are the threats. China and the globalists are the threats. China and the globalists. Let me explain something, folks. We have foreign multinational banks that got 76% of the banker bailouts. Okay? We are wide open. We are a joke. These foreign banks will sell the same house 100 times. They will sell the loan 100 times in many cases. The average is like 25 times. It's total fraud. The globalists are an alien criminal world government system. And by alien, I mean outside of America, at war with nation states. And Putin has come out when the hacks came out 6 years ago that the Russians did do. They hacked the UN in East Anglia with over 1,000 universities coordinating fraudulent thermometer readings. Okay? Jacking numbers up because the earth started cooling. It stopped heating 20 years ago, started cooling a decade ago. It's a fact. Total proof of the organized crime. Putin said it's a plan to bankrupt nation states. All Russia's got is its minerals and its oil and other systems it's selling to Europe. That gives Europe value. It keeps energy prices lower. The globalists don't want that competition. Russia doesn't dare sell its aerospace or technologies because it'll all be used against them. Okay, and so the issue here is this is some love fest with Russia. I've never been there, but I know the history of it. The point is that it was already taken over by the globalists and put under 80-something years of hell, and Russia still has mixed feelings about it all. There's different groups there, but Russia now has dialed into populism, dialed into the Renaissance, dialed into Alexander Solzhenitsyn and Alex Jones. I'm not bragging, and I'm not going to tell you the behind-the-scenes stuff, but just believe me, Russia's listening. And so is the UKIP is listening, and so is Donald Trump, okay? And I'm not going to sit there and brag and tell you behind-the-scenes stuff, but little birds, presidential nominees told me that. No, I'm going to stop right here. I said, is this off record? He says, no, it's not, but I'm not going to repeat this.
Baby birdies.
This stuff, if I said it, would just be a big news story. I mean, big, okay? So I'm just going to stop right there. But just understand, the spirit of 1776 that we represent is worldwide. That doesn't mean America's going to run Russia or China or South Africa or Germany. It means the idea of the Renaissance and the open free society. We have the truth. We have the weapon. We have the light in the dark. We have what empowers, which is you. And you can look at the evil of the DNC leadership. Those are evil people who all hate each other. They're turned over to evil. And I saw a lot of goodness in people's eyes, a lot of love, a lot of passion, a lot of Americana in the people of every race, color, and creed I saw at the RNC. I mean, Leanne, what was the spirit like there? Then I'm going to your calls, I promise.
It was absolutely wonderful. I loved meeting so many different people, and they were so proud to come up and be like, I'm a black man, I'm voting for Trump. Heck yes, I'll speak on camera. You know, or Hispanics coming up to us and saying, we want to let people know that there are a lot of us out there. We're not ashamed to do this. We're not even
I get it all. And it's not just because they were there. It's not just because they went to that. It's all over Austin.
Right. No, I mean, it's everywhere. And I think that that's kind of a key point, is the Democrats really are pushing for collectivism and putting us in these groups, and they want everyone to say, oh, well, you belong to this group and that group and your group. So rather than acknowledging
which is racism,
our individualism, they don't want us to be individuals because groups are easier to control.
They want to make us all uncomfortable so we don't associate with each other. Just forget all the uncomfortable crap. We got red blood. We want freedom. It's over. Thank you, Leanne.
Thank you.
All right, I'm going to go to your calls now and take a lot of calls the next hour with Bracken joining us. Leanne, you're doing a fabulous job. It's great to have you here with us. I just love our crew.
Hey, by the way, I've got Billy Corgan calling, Skyping in at midnight tonight. He's going to be taking people's calls. I'm super pumped.
Is it at midnight or 11?
Well, I'm going on at 10. I'm from 10 to 2. But, I mean, we've got Stan Deo coming on. Rob Dew is going to be there co-hosting with. We got a full thing for you.
By the way, Billy Corgan has a lot of courage to come on. Every other rock star I get on, they give him hell. I know they've given him hell. And you know what Billy Corgan said? Big red, white, and blue middle finger. And we don't mean the red, white, and blue of the globalists using us for imperialism. We mean the real red, white, and blue. We're taking that flag back.
Absolutely.
And God bless you. All right, very exciting time to be alive right now. Operation Sleeping Giant now in full swing, almost 2 hours in the 28-hour broadcast. Have you spread the link? Infowars.com/giant. Little actions together move mountains. It's the little actions that are actually the biggest. Jason in Florida, you're on the air worldwide. Thanks for holding.
It's an honor to actually speak to you finally, Alex.
Good to talk to you, my friend.
This is awesome. I can't believe I'm talking to you right now. Anyways, just want to let you know, my background, my bloodline is Puerto Rican, Cuban, and Sicilian. I was born in New York. My father was born in New York. He's Cuban and Sicilian. My mother is Puerto Rican. I'm a big-time Trump voter. I'm voting for Trump. My mother is, too. I'm still trying to get my father to go that way. I went to see Trump here in Tampa. That's where I live. It was awesome, truthful, and funny. All right, they're poisoning us. They're poisoning the air. They're poisoning the water, and they're poisoning the food. These chemtrails are out of control. I go outside to cut my grass, and I have to cover, you know, it's crazy. It's like 6, 7, 8. You know,
and they admit there's a secret geoengineering program going on. The aluminum levels are going up. Exactly. Why are we all fighting with each other? There's a whole shadow government screwing us over, and Trump wants to try to take it back.
Exactly. And I'm outside.
I mean, don't we want a president in? Don't we want a president in that's an info warrior?
Yes, sir. And I'm outside. I have to cover my nose, my mouth, so I'm not breathing this crap in. I'm looking like I'm waging jihad on my lawn. All right? I want to say Monsanto. I think Trump's a touch on Monsanto, definitely. Hillary's tied with Monsanto. They give her money. You know, it's ridiculous. I mean, and
anything evil, she's involved in it. You just it's like Donald Rumsfeld. If it's evil, she's in it.
That's right. And I saw Clinton Cash last night. Awesome documentary. I challenge everyone to watch that and get your family to watch it as well. This is very important. I don't understand. I'm 31 years old. I don't understand what's wrong with some people. And my generation, and they just don't.
They're in a trance. They're in a trance. They think if they go with the system, that's what's cool and successful because it's the system. They don't know. You don't want to be in the system. It's designed to limit you and control you and ultimately kill you. God bless you from Florida, Jason. Thank you so much. Yeah, I mean, there's no choice here. Trump is somewhat unknown, you know. But I got to tell you, Hillary, we know what we're getting. You got to go against it. All right, John in Texas, Chris, Sean, Patrick, and others. Your phone calls are 70 seconds away. Hour number three is about to begin. I want to go to Tom in England. I want to go to Sean, Patrick, Chris, John, and others. Let's go to calls right now. Let's go ahead and talk to John in Texas. Go ahead, John. Thanks for holding.
Hi, Alex.
Welcome.
If history serves me right, during the First American Revolution, didn't our founding fathers send John Paul Jones to Russia to get his help in our fight for freedom?
We did get some help. In fact, I think he'd actually been in the Russian Navy, if memory serves. He'd served the Czars, if memory serves. That's right. And the Czars actually helped Lincoln, too, when the British. And again, I'm from the South. I had family that were high up in it, so I don't want to get into all that. I mean, I'm talking generals. But the point is they were manipulated by British intelligence to get into that war. The North was doing stuff that was wrong. But we were idiots to have that war. Sam Houston, founder of Texas, was thrown out of office as governor, even after Texas was in the Union. You know, he'd been the president for that because he wasn't for it. So, the Russians have been helping America since the beginning of the country.
And don't you think this may be history repeating itself with Vladimir Putin coming in, helping us with our second Trump revolution?
Well, that's because Russia always has the proto-globalists trying to overthrow it. I mean, they're always dealing with people are trying to take over Russia for 800 years. So, yeah, Russia sees what's happened to us. They're not stupid. They know we look. But before, Russia was conquered for 80 something years by a globalist infection called communism. The globalists put the commies in. It's a fact. So they've partially gotten that disease out, and then they see us totally infected with it. So, yeah, it's in their own interest to try to stop it.
So, I hope that I'm hoping that after watching that freak show in Philadelphia, I'm hoping that that Donald can and pull it out and save us. Because
wouldn't it be great to see the United States and Russia and everybody else allied against collectivism and communism, and we could reform China and humanity could really go to the next level? Imagine, notice the globalists always want us fighting with Russia. That's their plan. Imagine if those two European Western powers allied, what would happen to the world with that technology? And there are good people on both sides who want that to happen, but it's always being sabotaged.
It'd be heaven on earth. We would have true heaven on earth.
We'd have damn close to it. I'm telling you, humanity has unlimited potential. But there are globalists that are always stirring up crises to gain control. And top professors have brought this out. It's not just me. Crisis is their brand. They don't produce anything but discord and mindlessness. And the time for countries to have conquest over each other is over. It's now time to have innovation and healthy competition. Instead of obsessing on sports, we should be obsessing on technology, undersea development, mathematics, interspace travel, huge work projects. The rock stars in the school should be, you know, the kid that wins the science fair. I'm sorry, not the quarterback. Because what's the quarterback acting cool going to do once he gets out of college? He's going to go work at a corporation and be a yes man. We want innovators. We want poets and scientists and artists, okay? And fighters and trailblazers and innovators. I tell you, the heroes will be people that launch on a first colony space mission that's going to take, you know, 80 years to get to the next planet. I mean, that imagine watching that reality TV show. And, of course, by then our technology will advance so much that we'll have jump ships that meet that ship before it even gets there. But the point is, we're going to do it, and it's not going to be some Silicon takeover with the globalists playing God. Humanity is rising. The threat of the technotronic tyranny will be defeated. Thank you, John. Tom in England, you're up next, and then our guests. The Islamic attacks have gone from monthly to weekly to now daily to now multiple times a day. I have a stack of news to deal with on that. We're going to be talking to former Navy SEAL, best-selling author Matt Bracken of EnemiesForeignToDomestic.com for the balance of this hour. The full schedule of the 26 hours of worldwide broadcast that is left is up at InfoWars.com/giant, or simply go to InfoWars.com and you can see the breakdown page that has all the feeds and the schedule of who's coming up. We also have a lot of surprise guests joining us. Our crew on the ground in Philadelphia with the riots and the communists and the socialists, the Black Lives Matter people, Stan Deo, Joel Skousen, George Norrie, Billy Corrigan of Smashing Pumpkins, Lionel, Anthony Gucciardi, Gerald Celente, Jakari Jackson, and Diamonds and Silk, and so many people, I can't even keep track of it all, Nigel Farage. Powerful transmission, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm going to be back tonight after a few hours I'm about to continue broadcasting. I'm going to be back tonight. Leanne McAdoo is going to be here with the rest of the amazing crew and all the people behind the scenes. I want to go to a few of your calls before we go to Bracken. We're getting him on the line right now via video Skype so that you can get your points out. Then we'll take calls while he's on with us as well, because he's a well-rounded, smart guy and can comment on your geopolitical questions and comments. But undoubtedly, the police and military now get it. It's gone from being something that we thought was happening to we're sure of it now, 100%. The Democratic Party, working with multinational corporations, is beta testing a real civil war in America, activating Black nationalists, Hispanic nationalists, Islamics, and when they attack, then civil emergencies declared, and then those that are critical of the takeover are the people that get arrested. Germany has now repealed its law post-World War II from 1945 in the Bundestag, the Reichstag, in both upper and lower houses, to allow military on the streets for civil emergency and martial law. They're under civil emergency, so is France, and they are arresting anyone even trying to demonstrate about open borders. This is the total completion of the tyranny. It's like your soldiers opening the drawbridge to the Huns or the Mongols. If you go back in history, this is unprecedented treachery by the left. It's against their own interest, but they have such a hatred and such a desire to pull down the Renaissance They're Jacobins. If you study the French Revolution, it was different than ours. They were basically devil worshippers. And I've had top historians on, you name it. They all concur. Communism came out of the Jacobins. They wanted to have a 9-day work week, change everything, break up all the families, have like local slave masters that owned everyone. But they were calling it liberal to overthrow the civilization to bring in a hell. And George Orwell wrote about that in 1984, where O'Brien's torturing Winston, who's his archetype from the BBC or the Ministry of Truth. And he says, we want a world more ugly, where you live less, where you're ugly, where you're starving, where we stomp on your face forever. We're the priest of power. We want to just hurt innocents and destroy everything and then burn your body and shoot it into the atmosphere. And we're not going to stop till we kill everyone and we'll finally just annihilate humanity. And you're like, wow, Orwell, this is really whacked out. He was a British secret police officer in India. Then he ran away and was like a communist and did all this stuff. Then he went and fought in the Spanish Civil War, highly decorated. Then he went and ran propaganda in World War II in OSS at the BBC. And then he ran off, wrote that book, thought people were trying to kill him, and died 6 months after it was published. And I've read his white papers. He totally woke up to realize that communism was the ultimate evil and run by the elite. So we're going to go to a few calls and go to Mr. Bracken. I'm going to go to your calls, bam, 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 so make your point, jump to the next person. But this is an epic time to be alive. We're now 2 hours plus into Operation Sleeping Giant. We're going until 3 p.m. tomorrow live, Infowars.com/giant. And we've got the biggest specials in our history. I keep saying every few months, this is the biggest ever because they're getting bigger and bigger. 40% off Brain Force. We've got a bunch of other specials I'll tell you about. But they did run out at My Patriot Supply, now the biggest storable foods manufacturer in the country. They've only been around 8 years. They're the biggest because they have the best prices, highest quality. They consolidated a bunch of top Mormon companies that are the best at it up in Utah. Very clean, quality food. We private label it to go even lower than even they do to get around their contracts with other distributors. That's the kind of business guy I am. I figure out ways to go even lower because I want to dominate the market. I want to fund ourselves and give you a great deal. Win-win. They are backordered a couple weeks. Okay. Now, in most places, it's months and months, but they usually aren't. That's how fresh it is. But I twisted their arm. They said, look, only 24 hours, Alex, and that's it. And we will accelerate it just for you because you're our number one seller worldwide. 20 to 40% off, depending on which food packages it is. InfoWars Select Storable Food, InfoWarsStore.com, 24 hours only. Like, they only said 24 hours, so I had to wait 2 hours to launch it because it has to end tomorrow. It has to end tomorrow at this time. Okay, because, I mean, they can get in a lot of contractual issues with that. But if you want to take advantage of that and get ready, InfoWarsStore.com. Okay, that's how we fund this operation. Let's go to Tom in England. Tom, thank you for holding her on the air worldwide.
Hi, Alex.
Yes, sir.
Thanks for going to me expeditiously. I do appreciate it. Mm-hmm. And good luck with your marathon broadcast.
Thank you.
I wanted to make a point about the false flag attacks that have happened, the San Bernardino, Orlando, Paris. Now, I'm going to say something controversial and say that these were not Islamic terror attacks. They were establishment terror attacks with an Islamic label on it. And let me just explain why that's pretty clear. I find it fantastically unlikely that they're going to bring people in who are likely to do attacks and let them get on with it. Because that takes away the fine control over when it happens, how many people are killed, how intense it is, what it distracts. But, you know, there are a myriad factors.
Sure, but the globalists aren't all powerful. The false flag is that they're letting in people from radical regions who they know are terrorists, in many cases have already committed crimes, to use that to bring in a civil emergency. I believe it's a false flag, but way upriver. Where, you know, where it's starting from. But, I mean, you can't deny that if you bring in 5 million people from radical Wahhabist areas, that you're going to get some terror attacks.
Well, what I'm saying is that that isn't the way that the establishment does things, and it never has been. They use professional operators to commit the attack, and then they put up patsies, and then the patsies die. And that's what's happened in all of these attacks. We've had patsies. You've got Joel Skelton on.
Okay, but let me ask you this question. Are the Wahhabis murdering Christians en masse in Syria?
They certainly have done, yes.
Sure. I appreciate your call. Look, when NORAD stands down and the head of the embassy tries to block 15 of the hijackers coming in, they're told to stand down, and the FBI comes out and says we were ordered to stand down, and you got all these weird drills going on, something went on. It's not the whole government, but something went on. And the deal with Saudi Arabia was take the blame partially, we'll attack Iraq and take them out. But it doesn't mean there isn't radical Islam is what I'm getting at. I'm going to go to more of your phone calls here real fast because I've got to go to our guest Bracken, start of the next segment, because I want to get into all this with him. We'll get his take on it as well. Let's go ahead and talk to Chris in Georgia. Go ahead.
Yes, hello, Alice. How are you?
Good, sir. Go ahead.
All right, just three quick questions. Do you think Putin is a traitor to the New World Order? Is Pence against it? And it's said that Trump has black employees moved out of sight when he comes to one of his places. It said
for some reason, your phone to me is just distorted. You said, is Trump, just back off your phone a bit, is Trump a traitor to the New World Order? Absolutely. Russia still has globalist tentacles in it. And I'm not saying Russia is perfect in and of itself, but Putin is fighting the globalists, fighting the New World Order. They've got programs to have kids, programs for the family. They openly talk about it on air. Now, what was your second question?
My last two questions were, is Pence against the New World Order? And it said that Trump has...
Yeah, I don't think Pence is perfect. He's a lot better than Kane, and he needs him to be able to run both sides of the aisle, so he's got him in there as a technician. It's all on Trump to make sure that he continues... his policies once he gets in. What was the third?
It said that Trump has black employees moved out of sight when he comes to one of his places. It said that he was sued by the Justice Department for refusing housing to blacks. I'm black and support Trump.
I hear you. Listen, the Justice Department sues everybody who's got more than 20, 30 employees. The EEOC runs around and all these groups, and then people who make professional money out of claiming they got kicked out of an apartment or something because they were a minority. That's a whole business of ambulance chasing. The guy owns hundreds of buildings. That is just crazy. And that's the kind of fables they put out. Like I had a guy call in and go, Putin's banning evangelicals in Russia. He's letting every Christian group in, do whatever they want. I said, where's your proof? Oh, I don't have any. I just heard that. It's bull. It's bull. Trump is known as being more inclusive than anybody. That's always been his trademark, both in management and who he hires and who he employs. He wants the job done. So, again, this is the kind of stuff they put these rumors out that have no facts or no information behind them. Now, I'm going to go to Sean, and I'm going to go to Patrick, and I'm going to go to Ben and Ethan and Christian. But first, we've got our guest coming on after the break, Matt Bracken, to get into the fact that, as he said a few months ago, he said it's going up exponentially. Or is logarithmically the term, where you get an attack every month, now it's an attack every week, it's an attack every day, now it's an attack every 6 hours. What is the whole point of this? I've got stacks of these attacks. Young Welsh girls held in boxes, threatening to murder people at nudist beaches or pools. Murders, bombings, killings, shootings, beheadings. And the media changes the name from Ali to David, or won't say it's Islamic when they pledge allegiance to Al-Qaeda or ISIS and scream, Allah, Allah, Akbar! Snack bar, all of this stuff is going on. What's the larger plan? All this and more straight ahead. It's Operation Awaken the Sleeping Giant. Infowars.com/giant. Have you spread that link? Joining us a little bit in the next hour is Matt Bracken. You see the full schedule of who's going to be on the next 25 plus hours we have left to broadcast in this special marathon live transmission at Infowars.com/giant. And yes, this is, we don't call it a money bomb, but it's a fundraiser. You can make straight donations if you want. Great products from water filters to non-GMO seeds to storable foods to shortwave radios to Hillary for Prison shirts and Molon Labe shirts. And look, it's all about funding, getting the truth out, and getting high-quality products. But I'm going to stop right there. Matt Bracken, again, is a best-selling author, enemiesforeignanddomestic.com, former Navy SEAL, patriot, very humble guy, but a lot of smart folks in the Pentagon said, look, we can't tell you the stuff we know. Just get Matt Bracken on. That's very accurate. And, I mean, here we are. You were on months ago saying, watch it become exponential. It is becoming exponential. We'll go over three or four attacks a day now with them saying they don't know why the guy cut the priest's head off, even though he pledged allegiance to ISIS, changing the name from Ali to David on one of the bombers, saying a Muslim was blown up by a bomb when the Muslim blows himself up. I mean, this is beyond 1984-level disinformation. What is the establishment doing? What phase is this? Matt Bracken.
Well, I would call this maybe the great treason. we're seeing something that I've never could have imagined before in Europe and in America. I sometimes think of this 1930s example. Imagine if FDR had ordered J. Edgar Hoover to scrub all mentions of Nazis, Gestapo, Himmler, Hitler, and drop all investigations involving Germans. And any time that there was a German involved in espionage, it had to go through a special German-American Bund liaison that would be provided to the FBI. And then imagine the FBI agreeing to all these terms, purging, scrubbing, etc. Well, that's actually happened. So at the Department of Homeland Security, Customs, Border Patrol, FBI, they're in the tank. Over in Europe, we can see the terrible math for the police. In Munich, one shooter with a Glock 17, although there were reports of long guns, a lot of times these are, like in Dallas, like in Baton Rouge, people are making concurrent reports from different directions. They get picked up as multiple shooters. So we really don't know. But assuming it was that one guy with a Glock 17 and 300 rounds of ammo, allegedly he bought that on the internet, I doubt it. In Europe, please. Somebody handed him a Glock 17 and 300 rounds. That's the key, is the somebody that handed it to him. But it took all 3,000 police and military that they had. They were bringing people in from other German states. 3,000 to react to one pistol shooter who was dead. They found out was dead. They just didn't find his body for a few hours while this panic went on. Subway system closed down. People leaving the city like it was under attack from aliens. Now imagine when a Mumbai with multiple shooters or a Paris Bataclan with multiple teams of shooters roaming around, shooting up a place, then hiding their guns, fleeing with the refugees, and then rinse, repeat. We saw in Dallas and Baton Rouge, the police can't even protect themselves. They have to call in more police with long guns because the initially responding police become overwhelmed. What happens in this country when we have multiple shooters like the Washington snipers of 10, 15 years ago? Imagine when that's happening every day and the guys aren't suicidal. They just get in their car and drive somewhere else. So we're going to have a big problem, and local law enforcement is going to be in the crosshairs. They're the initial responders, but I'm telling you that there's a huge division and split right now between the feds and local. As we've seen under Obama, the feds are trying to take over all the local law enforcement by having these DOJ bogus investigations.
And now like the UN Strong Cities Initiative, the double is going to run them. Have you seen the footage out of Germany where the Islamicist beats up the police for no reason and they can't even take the guy down? I mean, that shows the type of social workers they're hiring over there, because, boy, the German police.
In an airport. And the guy had a satchel. The guy's got a satchel swinging around, which could have been, 4 pounds of TATP or Semtex.
And the Germans will cover it up because that's their order.
Right next to this guy, you'll see in the background running interference are these women in burkas. Now, this is a guy that you need to shoot immediately. That's a deadly force authorized based on that guy having a bag, which could have detonated.
Absolutely. A guy starts attacking you in an airport there for no reason, blast him.
And even if he he's got nothing in there but a Quran, what he's doing is and we've seen this over and over again, the flying imams after 9/11.
Probing.
And today they don't have to make a report back to headquarters. The report is the YouTube video, which gets shared all around the world. Like, the one guy can tie up 3,000 police officers. You think that other people aren't learning that lesson? So, we're just in the beginning stages of the tech.
So right now they're just probing and getting intelligence.
Right, and using social media to share it. So it's dispersed. There's no, central nest. Like, if we only found the headquarters in Raqqa and bombed it, that wouldn't make any difference. It's like trying to kill a jellyfish swarm by shooting 10
random
jellyfish.
And our own supposed government is bringing them in. We'll talk about why straight ahead with Matt Bracken. I'm Alex Jones. All right, your phone calls are coming up in about 10 minutes or so with Matt Bracken. I got him on about 20 minutes late because I was taking calls. We can hold him some of the next hour. You are looking here at our live 28-hour broadcast. We are already 2.5 hours into this, so we have 25 hours and change left. Everybody from Billy Corgan of Smashing Pumpkins to Nigel Farage, the former leader of UKIP, the modern George Washington of Europe, total patriot. All this is coming up and so much more. Our live crew in Philadelphia. I'm not going to belabor this, but it takes money to win a war. We don't have George Soros's $25 billion. We don't get taxpayer money like MSNBC got $3 billion, or more, actually. Part of that $5 billion went down to them, to NBC. We don't get $450 million a year like NPR and then beg for money every week. Once a year, we have a super mega sale, and we also have donate buttons to help us kind of gauge if we can hire some more crew or continue running operations like we are. I really want to grow in the face of this. In fact, that's why I've gotten in the position of not even really taking profit at this point in the year, because sure, I need to have some money put back. I need to be able to be secure. I need to be able to handle any unforeseen things like lawsuits or whatever that don't really happen, but knock on wood. Literally, is there any wood around here? But you couldn't put your money towards a more important fight. I don't think anybody can deny that now, how we are affecting the globalists, controlling the narrative at the RNC and now DNC, how InfoWars is really leading the way on how to effectively take on the New World Order. And it's amazing. Our guests, our listeners, this entire family is incredible. So that's why we try to give you the very best water filtration system for your shower, for the water you drink, for the lowest prices that really just cut all the garbage out or bring it down to non-detectable levels. And that's why we have the very widest selection of non-GMO open-pollinated heirloom seeds. It's why we've got the huge selection of books and films and patriot apparel to meet like-minded people and to spread the word and to promote the culture of liberty. It's why we have the very best solar panel control systems and solar panel systems out there. Again, I mean, we've gone out and found the very best units for the very lowest prices. It's what we're doing, and we have 20 to 40% off basically everything in the store. 40% off Brain Force, an amazing nootropic. We've got 30% off Survival Shield, Nascent Iodine X2. We have 20 to 40% off on the storable food that's only back ordered a week or so. It's going to be so fresh. They're producing it right now. We had to really twist their arms to do it. We're powered by My Patriot Supply. It's InfoWars Select. We have their full spectrum of food at InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsLife.com. We have 30% off Liver Shield, 20% off all the Patriot apparel, 20% off all Survival Seeds, 30% off Supermelon Superfemal Vitality, 30% off Survival Shield X2, 20% off all ProPure water filters, 40% off Brain Force, free shipping on orders of $50 or more, 10% off additionally on top of everything when you sign up for an item on AutoShip. Pick 15 days, 30 days, 3 months, 6 months, a year, whatever you want. So you don't have to go back and reorder. Because I believe in you reap what you sow. So everything we promote is a really good value, super high quality, whether it's vitamin mineral fusion or the joint formula and bone formula, or whether it's colloidal silver or the great natural sleep aid knockout or ozonated olive oil for your skin. It's all there. Oxy powder to flush out your guts. It's all there. Prostaguard. I mean, one thing like saw palmetto of this dose is like $19.95. This thing has like 8 or 9 ingredients of the same dose level of everything known to be good for your prostate for $22. I mean, that's what I'm talking about. Super good values, super organic, highest testing levels. That's what we're committed to. Plus, we know we're a target of the Food and Drug Administration, so that also helps. But we would be this clean, this perfect, quite frankly, without it, because we know we've got a lot of folks shooting at us and don't want us to be able to self-fund our operation. Okay, going back to our guest, Matt Bracken, author, researcher, former Navy SEAL, a man warning for the last few years of the Islamic Tattoo, a man warning just here 3-4 months ago that he believed going into this fall, working with Western governments, globalists, that they were going to escalate the jihad attacks from one a month to one a week to one a day to 4 or 5 a day. I now have a stack here of 4 or 5 attacks the last day. And I mean, a new level. I think he called it the total treason or the absolute treason, where they changed the names from Ali and the Islamic name to David Jones. I mean, literally, David, where they say they're not Islamic as they scream Allah Akbar and blow people up. Or they say they're the victim of a bombing. Or they cut a priest's head off and they said at first, oh, a crazy man cut someone's throat. So this is all happening. He just talked about probing. So he's been right so far. Matt Bracken, what do you expect to happen next?
Well, there's going to be a continuing escalation of these because it's like a jellyfish swarm. They're sending out the pheromones like a termite nest. It's not a command, you know, top-down command structure. It's more like pheromones or jellyfish. So people see these things and say, "Well, I can be a Nike jihadist." They call them Nike jihadists because you just get into your head, just do it. You can grab a knife and just run amok. Just do it. You get your 72 virgins. Now, an important fact is,
by the way, I want to tell these dumbasses something. You're not going to get 72 virgins. Plus, whoever wrote that should know who wants virgins anyway. Sorry, go ahead.
They believe it. But if they believe it and they've grown up in some, pestilential third world hellhole, and they've seen fantasy pornos on, a tablet somewhere, and they're told this is what you're going to have the moment you blow yourself up forever, and you're just some dumbass inbred 1,400 years of first cousin consanguinity, inbreeding. You're going to have a lot of these Nike terrorists, whether it's with a knife and axe, mixing up some TATP. That Central Park bomb that blew off a kid from a tourist's foot, they said a few weeks later it was definitely TATP. The way I read that was a chemist going online and practicing. So you leave it. It's very unstable. Concussion in the right, when it's at the right dryness, stepping on it would detonate it. So you put it on a trail where somebody's going to hop off of a stone onto the trail. And sure enough, it worked. So I would assume that that chemist is now in mass production and also teaching other chemists. In the Islamic State, they held the University of Mosul, Iraq, for a long time in their Manhattan Project there while they had research laboratories, petrochemical industry level research laboratories, teaching chemists to make TATP wholesale and to teach other chemists.
And teaching folks how to nerve gas dogs.
And anything. But what we're going to see next is we're going to see the media continuing to run interference, and we're going to see our treasonous fools at the top, like Jay Johnson of DHS. I have to say, at this point in 2016, with people screaming Allahu Akbar every day and wiping people out, wiping out infidels, anybody in a position of authority or in the media who is promoting the mindset that there's nothing to see here is either a covert convert, or as the Muslims say, a revert, because they believe everybody is really an Islamist underneath, just trying to get out. So people like Jay Johnson, they're either a convert and they're just lying using taqiyya, or they're already making their dhimmi deal. A dhimmi is that, a status of a second class citizen.
And by the way, I'd read about this years ago. I'm confirming this really goes on, but I did more research once you brought it up and everything clicked. That's why Merkel and Hollande and all these people, you're absolutely right. And actually, I went to Islamic sites, they're bragging that, look, they're doing as we say to get in the next phase of money and payoffs. They've got to let them kill us and then have them take it over. So Obama and everybody is showing their good dhimmis. And now that the mayor is Islamic in London, he's openly saying all this now, letting folks know that we are his slave. Go ahead.
The dhimmi, a non-Muslim dhimmi has to pay the jizya tax. And for these people in the process of committing the great treason, their bride price, their dhimmi tax, their jizya, is to betray us while looking at us in the eye and saying, I have no idea, like Jay Johnson at the Senate Intelligence Committee hearing a couple weeks ago, waving his hand and saying, I have no idea about this purge of all the Islamic words. I mean, like I said, imagine FDR telling Hoover and the FBI to purge everything about the Gestapo, SS, and Himmler, and Nazi National Socialism, and to have no investigations of Germans unless the German-American Bund was there to make sure it was not prejudiced against Germans.
And let's be clear for folks that don't know history. Tell folks who the Bund is. Flesh this out. People forget that the government's been ordered not to say Islamic in terror. Now Twitter's censoring it. Explain this.
People need to read Phil Haney's book, See Something, Say Nothing. He was basically in shut out and purged within the Department of Homeland Security, where he was a subject matter expert. And eventually, by 2009, they just scrubbed all the books, everything that the FBI uses, all of their investigations. That's why they say, oh, it's another lone wolf. He was radicalized on the internet. See, the internet is a safe boogeyman. And of course, the solution is
Free speech is bad. Free speech is bad. That's who's to blame.
But it's really the mosques. This is the level of treason. I call FBI now, I call them faking bogus investigations. They used to say their other name was fidelity, bravery, integrity. Now it's faking bogus investigations.
And now the mosques are testing that they're allowed to preach and push this. That's why it's escalating.
And we are allowing radical imams, quote unquote imam, which would be like sending some Gestapo agent and saying, oh, he's a member of the, you know, the Nordic, what was the Germanic Odin religion. Yeah, he's an Odin priest, and we need to send him around to all the German clubs all over America in 1930s. And if you say anything about it, you're a Germanophobe. Well, right now we have these radical imams, these Muslim Brotherhood terrorists. They're going from mosque to mosque, passing out trunkloads of Wahhabist textbooks that preach murder and jihad. They are passing them out. They're funding these Wahhabi madrasa schools where the kids are just going to be.
Let's not forget the imam in Florida who even has a TV show on broadcast TV a month before was saying, murder the homosexuals. It's a favor to them. Kill them.
And it's so embarrassing to see the FBI today roll over like this. I can't imagine J. Edgar Hoover, the old FBI agents that I knew, you know, 20, 30 years ago, they must just be tearing their hair out to see their bureau destroyed and made a punk for these Muslim Brotherhood imam terrorists that are going from mosque to mosque. But the FBI is forbidden to go anywhere near the mosque without calling the liaisons from these Muslim Brotherhood front groups that are now running and directing our policy. I mean, it's Huma Ahmadin, it's the whole, you know, it would take all day to list all of these Muslim Brotherhood actors that are now running our foreign policy.
Let me ask you this question. If it's exponential, which it is now, you predicted that when this wasn't happening, just, you know, a couple years ago, and then 6 months ago, and 3 months ago, and a month ago on the show, if it's now gone from monthly to weekly to daily to every few hours, what's happening? What comes next?
Well, in Europe, we're very fortunate here in America because we get the war game out, the worst case scenario, because it's unfolding in Europe. In Sweden, for example, the police spend 90% of their effort cracking down on right-wing extremists that are complaining about the Islamic takeover. They don't go to the mosques and throw people out. So we can see in this country, from the top down, the suborned and sold out, took a dive, disgraceful FBI, they are going to continue with the towing the line that we're bringing in refugees, and anybody that's against the refugees, that's who we're going to investigate as a hater, not the people that are bringing in these. Imagine this is like the refugee thing is a two-pronged attack. Currently, right here and now, it's biological warfare. When you read about a half dozen people with drug-resistant tuberculosis being dropped into some medium-sized town in your average flyover
state. That's bio-warfare. Anybody else flying with that, it's a felony if you know you have it. 22%. Associated Press admits of the Minnesota folks that have been brought in have TB.
Right. And so this is bio war that's right now. So these kids in come end of August, they'll be in middle school next to your son or daughter coughing. That's bio war. And in the long term, these kids are going to grow up like the Tsarnaev brothers. They're not going to ever assimilate. Their religion orders them not to assimilate. So when you see these dimmy politicians saying, we haven't done a good enough job of assimilating our Muslims. Excuse me. Muslims have a book which commands them not to assimilate, not to have non-Muslim friends, to lie to us, and always to advance Sharia. See, the real division within Islam is not moderate or non-moderate Muslims, moderate or radical. It's a division between the tactics of slow stealth hijra. We're just going to take it over like the Muslim Brotherhood has taken over our government. We're just going to bring in refugees until there's nothing you can do. At the other end are the violent jihadists that believe in shooting and blowing people up and driving over people.
Sure. What do you make of the caller earlier calling from London saying, oh, these are all false flag attacks?
Yeah. There's some department somewhere where they've got all these actors. It's bogus. But like you said, the false flag is at the top. It's the people that open the gate. If Farmer Jones has a hen house and he catches a fox in the woods and then he sticks the fox into the hen house,
he's part of it.
We don't blame the fox. We blame Farmer Jones. And then if Farmer Jones says, I have no idea how that fox got in there, then you show a tape of him and he's, you know, videotaped him. You've got him
busted.
That's my next question. How do the political
elite? It didn't happen.
This is clearly a plan, Matt. This is clearly a plan. It's all accurate. You're right. How does the political elite think they're going to get away with it? Because they've announced martial law with troops on the streets in Germany, but for the right wingers.
At this point, the big show, like Brexit was a few weeks ago, is Trump going ahead by clear margins over Hillary. Hillary last night looked like that 1984 Apple commercial wearing her red Mao jacket. It was scary as hell. We're going to see, I think, if Trump goes ahead in the polls, assassination attempts to the level of airplanes blowing out of the sky. By what I mean is the stakes will be so high that the people that would put a bomb on a plane would be willing to have everybody else on the plane die. Make no mistake about it. At the level of Hillary Clinton, imagine if Trump wins and we've got Attorney General, Department of Justice being run by Giuliani, Andrew McCarthy, people like that. Hillary Clinton can wind up in prison. It's 10 years for each one of those top secret documents. She left them on purpose.
So she's a cornered rat, and absolutely, I think they're going to try to kill Trump or stage a false flag where somebody tries to assassinate Hillary.
Or we don't have an election because the security situation is so tenuous. If we have Mohammed and Malvo-type snipers driving around shooting people middle, end of October, there won't be an election. You know, the country will be on a crazy lockdown. So
you're thinking they may be, with all the Black Lives Matter and the rest of it, clearly thinking to have a civil emergency before the election.
Well, they've been provoking it. That's what happened with Dallas.
Sure. Undoubtedly. All right, Matt Bracken, we're going to come back, take some calls, then have you continue to break things down in the next hour as part of the 28-hour live broadcast. Ladies and gentlemen, the globalists have basically put us into a cultural trance. If you just wake up to it, it's over. And they're desperately trying to keep people in that trance. And I think they're going to bring in incompatible groups that are going to attack us. But by political correctness, then, we'll be taught and learned to stand down to it and go along with it. That's not happening. Just InfoWars is exponentially growing to be, in many cases, much larger than major mainstream media outlets. And when you put out the truth, it isn't like it has to be reapplied over and over again like lies. It's irrevocable. So when you spread the links to the podcast or the live feed or to the videos and articles we write, or when you support us and get high-quality products at InfoWarsStore.com with the biggest sales in our history running right now, 40% off on many of the nutraceuticals, upwards of 40% off on sortable foods, all of this, you fund this operation while getting a great deal. So be sure and check out InfoWarsStore.com today or InfoWarsLife.com. That takes you to the subpage where you can find all the nutraceuticals. We're going to take some phone calls for this segment and the next, and then we're going to continue with Mr. Bracken for one more segment about what we can do about this. We have never been in more amazing historical times. And I've been telling folks we're going into this for a long time, but it's here. And quite frankly, I can't come up with words to describe how serious this is. Who's been holding the longest here? Sean in Michigan, and then we'll go to Ben, Nathan, Jonah, and others. Sean, you're on the air. Welcome.
Hey, Alex, how's it going?
Good, brother.
Hey, I want to give a shout-out to Sean, my brother, Bleicher, B-L-E-I-C-H-E-R.
All right, brother, hey, I appreciate that. We can't do a lot of shout-outs, though, because sometimes folks do it to harass people. I'm sure you're a great guy, but we can't do it. Sean, what's your question for the guest?
Well, if he was to look at my Facebook, he would know who am I.
All right, I got to go. I appreciate your call, Sean. Let's go to Jonah in Canada. Let's talk to folks in Canada. Jonah, you're on the air.
Hi, Mr. Jones. How's it going?
Good. Go ahead.
I just wanted to call and get a little bit of a touch face on the video you released where Putin is warning the media about we're close to war.
Talking about Putin?
I've been researching and I've just been noticing that NATO is kind of instigating the fights over in Eastern Europe.
I'm glad you noticed. NATO's all along Russia's border. They've been supporting jihadis. They overthrew the Ukrainian government. I'm not saying Russia's perfect, but Russia is not expanding. The globalists are starting a war with them. Please continue.
Well, it's not even just that. It's the buildup. There's four battalions that are getting sent, and Canada is heading one, but the other ones are all going to the border.
They're doing war games and massing troops on the border, and proxy troops and mercenaries have been battling Russians in the eastern part of Ukraine for a long time. Let's get Matt. Let's get the rest of your take on that, caller. Go ahead.
Okay. Well, yeah, it's that along with the missile silos and everything that are going to be ready to fire upon Russia whenever they want. They say it's for defense, but it's just, it's more.
Sure, I know. But Putin came out a month ago and said this is in danger of nuclear war. Yeah, we move missiles onto your border. What would you do, Mr. Bracken?
Well, it's part of the same fabric, I think, to foment a crisis that's so bad that there would be blowback that would be believable and acceptable that we would perceive as being part of the larger war. For example, if the grid went down, if the internet went out, and when the internet came back on, assuming it ever came back on, people like you, me, and some others might not be around anymore. That's sort of the Turkish Reichstag coup, you know, but instead of a coup, you have a war that would be so devastating that we would just believe that, hey, the internet That's went right. down.
That's right. And Matt, stay there. We're going to come right back. Caller, stay there, Joan. I'm going to come back and let me have a comment back. But the globalists have created a huge Ponzi scheme to suck up all the wealth, build their yachts, their offshore bases. Now they need to burn the whole house down politically to distract from the heist they've done. And a big war historically is the perfect way to do it. Back in 70 seconds, I'm Alex Jones. Truth is, we're the real liberals. Those that promote Orthodox Islam and globalism and communism are the losers. They can't compete with an open society. They don't want to be on a level playing field. That's why they're despots. And that's why it's time for the sleeping giant that is humanity to rise up in the information war and affect the future battle space. So when the New World Order launches its final takedown, they will be brought down and not us. All right, Jonah in Canada, finish comeback to what Bracken just said to your point.
Perfect. Yeah. So like I was saying, the buildup of forces in Eastern Europe is the biggest threat to human survival.
Yeah. If the Russians were massing troops on our border like that, I would be saying get ready for war. I would be pissed.
Yeah. And obviously Russia is just going to counter that by bringing more troops. And then our media only reports that. So then it looks like, oh, they're going to say they're building troops, so we have to build more troops.
Exactly. Let's go back to Bracken. Great point. Here's the issue. Russia compared to us more and more is like promoting freedom because we're run by such authoritarians. What's the authoritarian, because you're a soldier, smart guy. What is the calculus on just starting a war with Russia out of nothing and trying to hype it in the media and having the heads of NATO and generals say, we need lots of dead Russians on Fox News?
Yeah, I was actually a Russian studies major, so it's kind of interesting for me in that way. I've always followed very closely going back through Russian history. I tie this directly to the DNC email scandal. You can see how the globalists, their immediate go-to boogeyman now is Russia. This is important to me more for as a matter of messaging and how the media can all take the same talking point. I saw something.
It's okay that Hillary stole the primaries because the Russians don't like it.
The Russian, but it wasn't North Koreans like Sony. You know, right away it was Russians. Now we have heard only a little bit of scan information that could actually point really that way. One of the things was something real simple, like, well, one of the hackers was using a Cyrillic language keyboard. In my world, that would mean not Russia, because at this level, unless it was just a Russian hacker, like, in his mother's apartment. But I mean, if it's Russian government level, then the false trail would be led through a Chinese keyboard or a North Korean keyboard.
Sure. But I mean, my issue is, who cares if Russia did it? They're exposing carbon taxes and Hillary stealing elections.
But here's the thing. Russia would have less motive than anybody. So to me, this is a false victim targeting thing by the globalists. Because if the Russians, I assume that they have all of the 30,000 emails, the top security stuff included, that was on her server, along with the Iranians, the Chinese, and anonymous hackers, they would want Hillary to be in the White House so that they could blackmail her, so they could dangle some damning top secret SCI, SAP program stuff.
That's a good
and
point.
Say, this is in Drudge Report tomorrow, unless, we do this deal. But as far as a war with Russia goes, I think that once again, it's a question of trying to ride the tiger and calibrate just when you're going to jump off. A plan to ride a tiger is not the same as riding the tiger. A plan to lead up to war with Russia, but not have a war, to just foment a crisis that'll be part of the background for why there's no election this fall is more likely. Now, a lot of wars begin where they thought it would just be a bluff. You know, we're just going to bluff them and they're going to back down. And that's how wars sometimes begin. But remember, both of these sides have nuclear weapons.
No, you're right. I mean, doesn't this, Matt, historically, though, show that we really have an out-of-control elite? I mean, this is all very reckless.
Well, the media, to me, is becoming a function. They're functioning actors now. The media that, for example, are still parroting Islamophobia and the biggest
total willing accomplices. Stay there. Let's talk about that, because never has the media been so in sync with the corrupt elements that have hijacked our government. More calls as well from Bosnia, New York, Tennessee, Canada, Florida. I have two different sheets. I have the 28-hour rundown of who's coming on, and then I have this other sheet just for the first 3-4 hours, and I didn't have William Binney, former technical director of the National Security Agency, who's going to come on and talk about the fact that they weren't allowed to look at Islamic terror. They were told to spy on everybody. That's when he resigned in 2001 after the attacks. And then they SWAT teamed his house, the rest of it. He said they had systems to absolutely shut this down. He's the guy that ran the operations against the Russians, one of the greatest mathematicians and code breakers ever. The guy's an idiot savant. I mean, he's not dumb when you talk to him. He's super smart. It's scary, scary smart, talking about the different ways they do these things. And I'm not bragging, but I was talking about some of the interdimensional lenses and signatures and things. And he was like, how do you know about that? And it was from doing some research years ago, my dad telling me about how they really break codes. And it's some pretty heavy stuff. But there's a lot of stuff going on. The point is that science has gotten to a very, very high level. And I'm just going to stop right there because I don't even completely understand it. But it's reached the level of, like, magic at this point. I want to ask Matt Bracken up next week, because so much is happening. This is intensifying. Unfortunately, his analysis more and more is coming true. And his warning is so important. I know we have loaded phones here from Bosnia and from all over the place. You'll get to talk to William Binney, obviously, when he is joining us. But just finishing up with Matt Bracken, clearly we have an insane elite, Matt, and I just hope that the Pentagon and others that have been more sane, like General Flynn, exposing that Obama and others were backing ISIS and Al-Qaeda, I hope that somehow we're able to derail what's happening. I'm not lionizing the Pentagon, but they seem to be really resisting a lot of this insanity because they don't want to, you know, have their grandkids killed or kids killed, I guess. They're not psychopaths. But the actual elite running things, these globalists, these socialists, these George Soros types, are very messianic. I mean, Soros has given interviews where he says he believes he's basically the Christ. These people are insane. And I don't see how we stop them, because even though they're frauds, even though they're collapsing, they're in power. And I agree with you. I think they're going to try to kill Trump. I think if Trump gets into power, before he actually gets into office, they might pull something big. I mean, we're seeing things happen in this country that have never happened before. And it seems like the establishment doesn't care what we know or what we do. They're acting like they know something we don't know, Matt.
Yeah, I think that the train is heading for a bridge that's not there, possibly. And that's what they know. And that they've got a plan for a siding, but the rest of us go over the edge. Then they declare it an emergency, and how unfortunate it is. As far as things that we can do, I think that, you know, I despair of waiting for any generals or senior FBI, SES is what they call senior executive service. Those are the civilian generals that run all of these agencies. I'm waiting for any resignations other than Phil Haney. I really haven't seen any, you know, whistleblowers, which is really a shame. So we have to accept the fact that FBI, DHS, they've been suborned. They're being run by Muslim Brotherhood, either knowingly or as useful idiots. But where it's going to matter is these refugees. The refugees are a battlefront. The refugees are part of this war. They're a fulcrum of this war. If your town accepts 100 Muslim men called children, but they could be 30 and they're saying that they're 16. If your town accepts them, your town is screwed. Your town just got 100 Hitler youth, for example, going back to my 1930s analogy. So we need to put pressure on law enforcement at the local and state level not to cooperate with the feds, who have clearly been suborned by Team Tyranny. So if, for example, if you're in local law enforcement and you're tasked with providing coverage at a demonstration where the FBI is going to come into town with a half dozen guys and they're expecting 50 local law enforcement to be their muscle, refuse to cooperate. The people that know when these secret flights are coming in at night getting loaded onto the big buses, taken to rehabilitated, bankrupt hotels, which are now being used as secret refugee transit centers. The people that know this information need to leak it. If you're not part of Team Tyranny and Team Treason, then you need to at least be calling Alex Jones.
That's right, because if you don't leak it or resist it, you're actually on that team. And
you'll be treated that way.
Here's my final point. That's it. Our own media and the European media, now the name is Ali. They change it to David, and then they give him an English last name as well, surname. They will not say when it's an Allah Akbar or pledge to ISIS. It's unified information warfare.
Yes.
That you wouldn't just expect your own government to use. It's such black propaganda that you would only expect it to be used by an authoritarian state. And then it's used against us. So what I'm saying is, I've never seen them take the gloves off like this and put brass knuckles on. This is clearly a military operation. There's got to be 100 times the refugees they're saying coming in. My alma mater has 231, and that's just a high school in Austin. All the other high schools have it. All the other sub-schools have it. Thousands per school, total from first grade to 12th. They say 400 in Texas total. Hell, it's 400 at two high schools. What is going on here?
Yeah, and the media that are acting as the mouthpiece, as the Goebbels, arm of it, the media are now players. The media that is selling this invasion by saying, oh, I had no idea. Look, if you have no idea in 2016, then you're either a useful idiot or you're a witting traitor. And we are going to start holding people to account, because we can all see when they're screaming Allah Akbar, when they're killing priests or driving people, kids over in a truck, when they're screaming Allah Akbar, we know what it is. And anybody who's at this point saying, we don't know what it is, we're looking for their motives, you are a traitor. FBI, please wake up, throw some cold water, take a cold shower. Think about J. Edgar Hoover in the 1930s taking a dive like you cowards, you disgraceful, dishonorable cowards that the FBI have done. I expect so much more from you. Covering up for the Muslim Brotherhood, looking the other way at these terror mosques. Then Orlando happens and you pretend you had no idea. It's disgraceful and dishonorable. And we're going to hold you to account. At Nuremberg after the last World War, I was just following orders, got people hanged. If you think your excuse is going to be, I was just following orders, that's going to get you hanged. If there's some super 9/11 that happens, there will be an accounting.
And it's Matt, I hear you, and I'm not defending the FBI and others, but in San Bernardino 2 years before, they were tracking the husband and wife going back to Saudi Arabia and Pakistan for training. They started a criminal Justice Department investigation on the two agents for investigating those two. And they are all over them, prosecuting them and firing them if they do. I think it really falls to us, the American people, even more than the FBI, for the fact that we're so passive, it's allowed this to happen. We got William Benny about to come on, who's the paramount.
I just want to ask the FBI agents, is your paycheck and your pension worth more than your honor, your integrity, and your country? Look in the mirror, Mr. FBI man. Fidelity, bravery, integrity. Is it integrity or is it just paycheck and pension? Seriously.
Well, I tell you, it'd be one thing if they were taking us over a couple generations. They appear to be doing this very, very quickly. And so we need to just do this for your pension. There's not going to be any future here. Obviously, things are getting so cataclysmic. Matt Bracken, thank you so much for the time. The website's thank excellent. You. The essays, the books, enemiesforeignanddomestic.com. We'll talk to you soon.
Thanks.
Now, joining us for the hour, I'm leaving in about 25 minutes because I've got to go get ready for the rest of the broadcast, is one of my heroes, but Anthony Gucciardi's going to come in and be talking to him and giving him the floor. William Benny, you talk about where are the whistleblowers. William Benny is one of the top code breakers, one of the top mathematicians. Just separately, Mainline News says he's one of the greatest code breakers in history. And this is a guy that helped defeat the Soviet Union. He's broken down already here previously that they were tracking Al-Qaeda and other groups, and specifically what was going on, but it only cost $20-30 million a year, or even lower. But they wanted to spend billions to spy on everybody, and so he resigned, tried to talk to Congress, as you're supposed to, legally and lawfully, and they said they SWAT teamed him, tried to prosecute others, and it's continued on with Obama, not just Bush. So he's the former technical leader for the National Security Agency, the guy that actually ran the NSA, not the political director, and basically the equivalent of a multi-star general before becoming a whistleblower in late 2001 after more than 30 years with the agency. Benny has been described as one of the best analysts and codebreakers in NSA history. He continues to speak out about the NSA's data collection policies and continues interviews in the media regarding his experiences. He's come to Austin to visit with us. He has a lot of courage. ExposedFacts.org, agoodamerican.org. That's the new documentary film that he and Drake and others are in. There's also obviously an Oliver Stone movie coming out dealing with all of this. And so here to talk about the film, here to talk about the latest developments, here to talk about what's unfolding is William Benny. William, thank you for joining us. Do we have him there, guys? Or do we lose him?
Yeah, I lost you there for a second, Alex. Yeah, but I'm here.
Good to have you, sir. Good to talk to you.
Well, it's good to be back with you.
Where do we start? I mean, I want to get into the film, what's happening in NSA, but just the fact that they know about these jihadis all over the place, even though when they're convicted terrorists, they're still letting them in. I mean, how do you respond to that?
Well, I just think they're all deluded. They're insane. I mean, they're not doing anything smart. I mean, you should let people into the country only when you could vet them and know who they are, where they're coming from, and what they stand for. I mean, otherwise, it's just like open borders and it's insanity.
Absolutely, sir. Where to begin with the NSA and what's developed since the last time you were on with us 6 months ago?
Well, since then, Alex, we've started a coalition of privacy groups and civil liberties groups inside the U.S. here, and we've got connections worldwide now, and we're trying to get that coalition is being joined by about 30 members of Congress, and we're getting this coalition to move to first to open up the DODIG report, which exposes all the crimes and fraud and waste that they've got, but it really goes into the reasons why they did this bulk acquisition data because there was so much money behind it. And there was so much corruption internally between the companies involved and the officials of the NSA. In fact, that report, according to my sources, implied that they let or referred two criminal prosecutions to the Department of Justice. So, and those, of course, went nowhere because if they opened up the can of worms there with those referrals, that would expose everybody to criminality, and they didn't want to do that.
So it's the same too big to fail. Hillary's too corrupt to jail because it'll bring everybody down. The banks are too big fail, so let them loot us.
Yeah, I mean, they're all a part of it, too. So you have to all stick together. I mean, if you're all criminals, one has to defend the other. That's the point.
Very well said, sir. Let's talk about A Good American, the new film that's coming out. Very, very exciting. It's a gripping docu-thriller about a groundbreaking surveillance program, the brilliant mastermind behind it, and how this perfect alternative to mass surveillance was killed by the NSA management for money 3 weeks prior to 9/11. I got to say, you got a lot of courage, what you did 15 years ago, what you've been doing since then, and now being in this film.
Well, yeah, the film basically goes through my career at NSA, and toward the end, it gets into what led up to mass surveillance, how we got there, and how they corrupted the entire process, and why they did it for money, of course, as the main driver, but also to build empires. They wanted to build empires in contracting and in government. That was also a large motive for them. But it also gets into saying that there was simply an alternative to mass surveillance that existed all along, and they suppressed that, and they did it because they wanted mass amounts of money. So we all got fleeced because of these criminals.
That's right. And then as you explained, but I mean, since you talked about this, you didn't go public to a few years after you first talked to Congress, but everything you talked about has been admitted that they surveil everything, so it's like needle in a haystack. Everything's worthless instead of targeted surveillance that's legal and lawful.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, it would have been very simple to get warrants to do the things you want to do. I mean, there's nothing, there was no impediment to doing that. That was true all along. And yet they made out that it was such a difficult process and all of that. That was just another pack of lies, which are all these lies are also exposed in the DODIG.
Plus, you don't need a warrant to target overseas assets.
No, not there, but in the U.S. you do, yeah.
Sure, but I mean, most of it is overseas. I mean, because a lot of the stuff's between the U.S. and overseas, you can always just target the overseas end, correct?
Yeah, but now you see what they're doing is over half of it is in the U.S.
No, I understand, yeah.
Their collection, yeah.
And we know it's being politically used. In fact, a lot of experts have talked about the fact that a lot of NSA is directly targeted in other agencies at people in their own agencies.
Yeah, that's right. And I maintain they used it against Elliot Spitzer because he was going after the bankers on Wall Street for criminality and defrauding people. So they had to get rid of him to protect their bankers.
Yeah, why did they go after Spitzer for a hooker? I mean, I'm not for him or against him, but there is this vitriol against Spitzer, and I just don't see how having a hooker is a reason to make a big national scandal.
Yeah, but I guess the protect the move. The probable cause for going after him was to protect their bankers, not for any other evidence of criminality. I mean, they had to go into financial transactions, credit card and phone and stuff like that to find something to use against him to get rid of him.
Wow. Now, let's say you're on national TV, which you basically are. This is a bigger audience than most national TV shows. What would you just impart in 5 minutes to the general public about what's happening in this culture?
Well, we're losing our fundamental rights. I mean, they're scrapping. I call it treason against the founding principles of this nation. They're subverting the Constitution, and they're doing it mostly in secret, and they're trying to get everybody over time, slowly, incrementally, like raising the temperature on the frog in the water till you get them cooked.
Yes.
That's fundamentally where we're at. We're in the water being slowly cooked. And at the end result is a state that's a total surveillance state, basically a totalitarian state for whoever's in the White House. So I think we're electing an imperial president, basically.
Sure. I mean, I know you're pretty much nonpartisan, but when you look at the fact that they try to say that superdelegates that they just created back in the 70s but never implemented could just nix delegates in popular vote, they failed with Trump, but with Hillary, Sanders clearly won most of the big states and would be the nominee, but they just had superdelegates decide that she would be the nominee. Unprecedented to see that type of behavior going on. And it just makes me ask, wow, we don't have a Fourth Amendment. Why even have voting? I mean, at a certain point, the bottom falls out.
Yeah. Well, plus, of course, the DNC, members of the DNC were kind of slanting the entire process against Bernie.
Well, absolutely. They stole the election from him, and the emails have come out. Yeah. So who do you think is really behind those emails, the latest ones getting hacked? They keep saying it's the Russians.
Well, I don't know. He has a problem. Hillary has with NSA. And I know that NSA, of course, had those emails. So also probably CIA, because they share. And many other countries in the world could also access them through different programs, IC Reach or X Keyscore. Those programs could get into that data. And by the way, to trace who's ever tapping into that, you could use X Keyscore, as Edward Snowden said, very easily to trace who's doing that. And, you know, they had some private company look in, and they looked for a specific set of attacks, which the Russians used, and they found one. So the Russians were hacking, so were everybody else in the world. So
I was about to say, it's like a feeding frenzy when you're feeding carp at the Japanese garden, because, I mean, everybody's targeting the DNC and RNC. They admit major agencies are spying on Congress. I mean, this is a free-for-all. So you're saying there's no way to tell where those emails came from, sir?
Well, I mean, you have to have a real good network log that goes into the DNC server. But as far as I know, they haven't done. I think that's probably what the FBI is going to be about. And there they'll be able to lay out how many people hacked in.
Well, why does it seem that Democrats are more sloppy than Republicans? I mean, maybe that's just a misconception, but it seems like they don't do much to protect what they're doing.
Yes, and in fact, that's one of the questions I had here, which got written up in a blog. If it was a known attack, why didn't they have a defense for it? If it's known, why they should have a defense for that? I mean,
when we have known attacks here every month, we have services that just update plugins, and we have security companies that are always updating stuff. Why don't they do that?
That's right. Yeah, exactly right. And That was the whole point. The other of it is that means, like, for example, in NSA, don't want problems fixed because that will close windows for them. They won't be able to see into other things or hack into them if those things are closed. So it'll make it more difficult. They'll make their job more difficult. So that's one of the reasons they
Let's be clear. They leave the internet with holes in it so they can run around stealing just as easy.
Yeah, because it's a window into whoever has that system or firewall or whatever it is they're hacking through. It allows them to get in to see what they're doing. That means they've got a problem. They can't.
William Binney, let me ask you this question.
Don't fix it.
Are things getting better or worse with spying? I mean, I know you're not in the agency anymore, but talking to your colleagues, I mean, has there been any reform or is it just getting worse?
I think it's just getting worse because they keep arguing they need more data when, in fact, even internally at NSA and analysts are saying data is not intelligence. You know, we're drowning in information and we can't figure anything out because there's too much data to look at. That's what's being said.
Because they're not profiling. Everybody knows you're profiled.
I'm sorry, what was that, Alex?
Because they don't do targeting. They're not targeting.
Right. It's just mass collection and dumping.
Wow. Well, tell me about the new film. I can't wait to see it. It's coming out in September, I'm told.
Yes, it'll be opening in I think, the 23rd of September here in the United States. And it's basically, we're going to be using it with this coalition of privacy groups and civil liberties groups as a lever to try to strike a hammer to open up that DOJ to the public, because most of what they redacted out of the report is unclassified, and that's really the knuckle busters for the intelligence agency. It exposes all their crimes and all their lying and everything to people. They came along and said everything was legal. Well, you know it wasn't. I mean, the Second Circuit Court of Appeals ruled their bulk acquisition was illegal, and so did federal judges. A couple of them have ruled it was unconstitutional.
Absolutely. Stay there. We'll do a few more minutes with our guest and a bunch of breaking news and more. Anthony Gucciardi's coming in as well. Stay there, Mr. Binney, a true American hero. We are the heart of the resistance against the globalist takeover, against the corruption, against the looting. It is an information war. William Binney, former technical director of the National Security Agency, the, quote, leader of the NSA was the title, is our guest. I'm going to keep for another 5 minutes. I appreciate his work. Then I'm going to get into some of Donald Trump's speech from earlier and some more of your phone calls from Bosnia and Connecticut and New York and England, you name it. Anthony Gucciardi is going to be taking over some, too. We've got another 24 hours plus coming up. I'll be back later tonight with this marathon 28-hour broadcast. Mr. Binney, the new film, A Good American, coming out in September. There'll be a trailer out soon exposing all this with yourself and other whistleblowers. Other points you want to impart to folks that they should know about?
Well, we're going to use the film as a lever to get a movement started in Washington, first to expose the DODIG report, but then to go on and move toward shifting this bulk acquisition out and forcing them into a targeted approach, which would be more productive and actually succeed. So this is kind of the lever we're trying to use to do that. And we, of course, need a little help to get that going. And that's on one of the links I gave you to if people want to help, they can look at that link and see the different ways they can do that.
Sure. Which link is that? Goodamerican.org?
That's actually the site for where we put down how to do a targeted approach. We're putting it on the web for everybody to read so you can see how you can do it.
Sure. So, I was given exposedfacts.org and agoodamerican.org. Can you pull up a site for folks to donate or to help spread the film?
It's the one it's the Kickstarter link.
Oh, good. That's a good American on Kickstarter. And so folks can go right there. It's there on screen. Please continue.
Yeah. So, and what we're going to be doing is trying to get them to start doing smart things and abide by the Constitution and the laws of the country instead of being a lawless organization, which is what we have now.
It's super dangerous. People think of a foreign power as a threat. Sure, it can be. But what about multinational corporations? What about combines in our own government taking over? Look at third world countries or Europe's history. That's usually the number one threat.
Yeah, absolutely. But now we've become the greatest threat. No country in the world was ever going to threaten us anyway. We were always too powerful. But we can't against ourselves. We can. After all, they the oath of office for everybody in Congress and in the White House and every employee of the government is to protect and defend the Constitution against all enemies, both foreign and domestic. Now, what we have here is a bunch of domestic enemies who are subverting the Constitution, and that needs to end.
Well, we just really appreciate you. In closing, unprecedented persecution of the press, unprecedented persecution of whistleblowers, clearly exposing criminal activity. Has that let up any? I mean, I know even liberals say Obama's the worst in history, more than any modern person.
No, they just sent Sterling off based on metadata to jail for a couple of years. So, I mean, you know, that's not let up. The whole point is when Obama came in and said, let's not look back, let's look forward. And he applied that equally to everybody except for whistleblowers. So anybody who exposed the dirty laundry of the government and all the crimes and fraud and waste that they were committing, anybody who did that was you prosecute them no matter what. You always look back and find them and get rid of them. That's what they're doing, and that's
right.
What they continue to do.
That's absolutely right. William Binney, former leader of the National Security Agency, thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Wow. The great part about my job is I get to meet honorable people. That guy could have been paid $10 million a year. He didn't brag, but I've read news articles at big corporations. I mean, top guy. I mean, inventor of most of the NSA stuff. I mean, that guy's like freakishly genius. And he wouldn't do it. He won't do illegal stuff. And he hates it that they use his technologies to spy on everybody. Like interdimensional stuff, because any big mathematical equation will have like a shadow. It's smaller than it's all this really sophisticated stuff. And that guy's like super genius, but see, he doesn't want to prey on people. And so there's the difference right there. He's one of the guys that broke the Russian codes, you name it. Now, let's turn his mic on real quick. Anthony Gucciardi's in here with us. We'll be riding shotgun a little bit in the next hour. What you say, Anthony? Yeah, he's an honorable guy because he understands you don't crap in the pool. Evil people think you do bad things, it doesn't affect you too, or your kids. And they wonder why they have such bad luck. But I tell you, I want to take a few phone calls here and then play part of this Trump speech today. The full speech is on Infowars.com. We're going to go to Nimiyaha, if I pronounce that right, from Bosnia, and a few other callers here in just a few minutes. Anthony Gucciardi's in here with us. I'm not going to belabor this. We're running the biggest specials. And I know I've been saying a lot, the biggest special here or there on one or two items. So we have thousands of items. This is the biggest special ever. 40% off on storable foods, 40% off on Brain Force, 30% off on a bunch of the other nutraceuticals. The lowest discounts are 20% off on the Patriot apparel, the Hillary rape shirts, the Hillary for prison, the Molon Lambe. Operation Sleeping Giant is live at Operation Sleeping Giant. You just go to Infowars.com/giant. And the small profit we make off each item hopefully will be outweighed by massive orders to give us the confidence to decide if I can hire couple more reporters, couple more camera people, couple more writers, couple more editors. I really need 6 to 15 people. And it's a hassle to manage folks, but we've got some good crew here and good folks to train people. And we just get overworked and overtasked trying to do 4 or 5 shows a day and work 7 days a week and be able to cover events in different parts of the world. We're doing it. I mean, Anthony and I were up here Saturday and Sunday. We're not bitching. It's just we were up here Saturday and Sunday. Anthony was up here Sunday for about 8 hours. I was up here about 5 hours. I was up there Saturday about 4 hours. So was he. And we're not complaining. We love doing this work. We want to train people so we're 7 days a week, but everybody doesn't have to work 7 days a week. And Rob Dew isn't having to work 18 hours a day and, you know, looking like he's not too happy, like a wet cat sometimes, which we all do. We get mad. But the point is that we're really busting our ass here. And we appreciate your prayers, your support. You cannot find a better place to get great products that are game changers and get a great deal and support, quite frankly, crazed maniacs when it comes to liberty. I mean, we've got the spirit of liberty. There's a reason we are kicking ass. When you see those hunchback crones and reanimated corpses and slithering demons, I love Drudge Report, Soros slithers into the convention. Weirdo Nazi collaborator, 85-year-old freakazoids. I mean, if we can't kick their ass, that's our fault. And here's the deal. We are kicking their butt. Here comes Wet Cat. Come on in here. You heard me talking about, look, he's wearing shorts and a sports jacket. Now, I feel bad for Dew. He'll be like, I've been working all week till 3 a.m. to finish these videos. I'm like, dude, don't work hard, but we have to. Because he's like, here, bring the, I didn't, this is not planned. Here's what
stuff's got to get done. And, you know, I finally feel like I slept 8 hours last night. I felt like I slept for a week. It was so, I mean, we're literally sleeping 3 to 4 hours a night. At these RNC,
we almost got in a couple fist fights.
Yeah, we did, but you know that's part of that shows how intense we are. We're intense people, you know.
And when it's 9 o'clock at night, you've been going since 7 a.m.
Yeah,
and the communists just attacked here, or the young Turks are taking your videos taking down. Your videos. You got to get crazy, exactly. Go to the next level.
Exactly, exactly.
But then we were like 6 more hours after that.
That's the way it is sometimes, you know.
Lord Palpatine, I tuned into the hatred.
You should be upset. It'd be weird if you weren't crazy, right?
Exactly. So, yeah, I'm coming up at 3 o'clock in just, 20 minutes. I guess you're going to finish out the hour. And
hey, Vitamin Mineral Fusion. Drink it every day. This wasn't even a planned plug. InfoWarsLife.com. So delicious.
I tell my kids, I go, y'all want some fruit punch? Hey, we want fruit punch. I'm making some fruit punch.
All the vitamins and minerals.
Exactly. And they love it. It tastes great. The kids love it. And
by the way, the ad we cut was before the 18-wheeler got here. It was with a little mini sampler one. It's like a lot bigger.
Yeah.
It's like hilarious. I keep saying recut that ad. Like, look, here's your little cup.
10 times bigger.
Yeah. That's like,
and it's good stuff. That Brain Force is amazing. I haven't even had Brain Force yet because I'm going to wait until the wee hours of the morning. So I'll be doing
you're not allowed to have any Brain Force right now.
I heard your Brain Force plug.
I've noticed the Brain Force is in an association we're really tired with.
Right.
It'll get you totally awake. Then you start. Something, it's bad, but when you're really awake, when you're super tired, it's like
picking out all the details.
Yeah, stimulants and being tired, you start getting a little grumpy.
It happens.
Maybe that's just you.
I haven't seen you today either. I get mean on it.
It's totally natural and totally healthy. It's just that if it's 9 o'clock at night, you got to work till 2 or 3 in the morning, and you take some, you're going to be awake.
Oh, yeah.
It's not like a coffee where you're kind of awake, you feel like crap, you're awake. You feel good. You want to kick, you know.
Yeah.
It's not good.
It does really work. Yeah.
It's exactly how I feel right now. Getting a little bit of sleep, I feel supercharged. But, when I came in and did that Louis Farrakhan interview, which is where that ad plays from, I was dead tired. It was 8 o'clock, and I'm like, there's no way I'm going to finish this. And the Brain Force, till 3 a.m., it was solid, like editing. You know, when you're editing, you're in the zone.
Just don't go too far.
Just don't take more than two.
And then don't do it 2 or 3 days in a row. See, what it's for is to take one at 5 when you got to keep working until, say, 10. Then it's okay. Don't take two, dude.
I took two. And I finished the project. All right, I'm going to go get ready.
But this way, they sell stuff at gas stations for like $20 for 2 pills.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Per pill. It's crazy.
That gives you a headache and doesn't work as well.
It's terrible.
This is $17 for a whole bottle.
They sell a lot of crazy stuff at the gas stations. Even Whole Foods, they have this new thing now is to sell one pill for like $20.
By the way, I wasn't on, dude. I just had to tell him, stop working so
He had to
so
come
much.
In because you called him a wet cat. So he had to come in
Less
the studio.
A joke around offices.
He had to come in and take the mic.
You know how a wet cat looks. You can go on. Yeah. No, dude's awesome. He's so into this, he won't stop. I'll tell you that. I said, dude, go home. But, I mean, once you get in this fight, you want to expose it because there's like stacks of... By the way, do we have the Hillary Hyena video? I want to play that. This was banned and removed off the internet already. And then they were airing it on national TV and it was removed. And I realized it. I always hate her laugh. She sounds like a hyena. Do we have that? Cue up the Hillary Hyena and then I'm going to take a few phone calls. And then maybe just later. I want to air a big... demon. There's something, I forget which national, I have an article on InfoWars.com, a national cable channel just played that as a joke, and they got threats and stuff and removed it, and then it's been being removed. Who was it? TBS, yes, TBS. In fact, we want to retweet that at InfoWars.com at Real Alex Jones. Let's play that again. Her laugh is indistinguishable from a hyena. And have you seen her now in public where she starts doing going, I mean, what do you think's going on with her?
Well, you know, maybe.
I almost want her just to get in. So she'll probably just launch nukes and just go, hail Satan.
Laugh like a hyena.
While
you can imagine that, just pressing the launch codes, which are 000, right? And she's pressing 000, laughing.
Remember for a while it was 000?
Yeah, 000.
The government's so inept. It's 00. No one even said it.
No one cared. No one even changed it at all.
Because they're also delusional on drugs. Yeah. Yeah. Here, let's, the word is Hillary's totally hopped up on drugs. Let's go ahead and play the hyena again. Ha ha ha! so fake. Kind of like go through a little Muppet in a field and sing with it. You know, like, oh, hi. I'm
that would be great.
I'm a psychopath, but you don't know it. Oh, hi, I'm sweet. You like that?
That would be good. And have a hyena in there. It could be a hyena even, actually.
A hyena puppet?
Yeah.
That's a really good joke. I want to go to some phone calls. It's Nijia in Bosnia. Welcome to the airwaves. Thank you for holding patiently. Are you?
Thank you very much, Alex. It's Nemanja, but I know it's very difficult to pronounce. Nemanja.
I'm from Texas. Yeah, like Manchaka right. Is Manchak. Okay, so I'm gonna textify your name. All right, Naman, go ahead.
Thank you very much. It's an incredible honor. I will try to go straight to the point, but I have multiple points, so we'll see how much time you'll give me. First of all, one thing which I have noticed recently is that in the United States and generally in the West, they use more and more this narrative of progressives, how people should elect a progressive for a society to move forward.
Cancer is
now,
progressive.
This narrative is, yeah, this is straight out of communist playbook. And I know it's because here, you know, Bosnia and Herzegovina was a part of former...
Well, sir, lean forward is the Karl Marx slogan. Yeah, exactly. No, they're using communist nomenclature. Go ahead.
Yeah, but what they're doing also, I remember, and I have books which have been printed, you know, during the communist era. The official narrative, you know, in the first years of communism was that the, you know, someone who is in opposition to the system is a counter-revolutionary, so he should be executed or imprisoned. But later, it became sort of a trendy, you know, thing, something of what is happening to you in the West right now. So the narrative was that communism was progressive, and everyone else is backward, ugly, stupid, you know, unworthy of any recognition. So if there
is... Yeah, that's it. Communism is the future. It's going to create eternal life and space planes, but it can't even produce a car.
Something like that, yeah. Now, the another thing which I have noticed also, I think that, you know, people in the West, basically you were taking for so many decades democracy for granted. And I think that many people haven't noticed something that we have noticed here, and that is that democracy is no longer, you know, taught as a value, you know, in the West. It's no longer something which is to be understood as a virtue in its own. It is simply a tool which is only as useful as it serves its purpose, you know. Because this is what...
I agree, but I just want to know why we treat Madeleine Albright, a mass murderer, like a rock star, when she looks like a bloated maggot in a blue dress.
Great question, because, you know, here I'm a Serb from Bosnia, and, you know, we here Serbs have really had the chance to...
You've already enjoyed the Clintons running a jihad on you and giving one-third of your country to them.
Absolutely, yeah. This is exactly what we have felt, so many people here have been...
And how'd you like those liberal DU bombs on civilian targets? Very liberal.
You see, well, we are not in the European Union, so we haven't seen any, you know, terrorist attacks here yet. However, they may come very soon.
Because, some of what happened to Serbia, though, when they bombed Belgrade.
Yeah, well, Serbia has been defeated, and unfortunately it has been taken over by globalist minions who have been in power since the year 2000.
And I'm told it's a beautiful country. Everybody I talk to says that whole area is as beautiful as it gets.
It is beautiful, but I want to also bring another idea, you know, because I have heard today on your show there were guests, and also you are saying that European leaders are demons who have sold out to the Muslims, etc. I think, I mean, if you're interested in my opinion, I think that these European leaders are simply globalist minions, who have an intellectual capacity which is maybe enough to run, you know...
No, I agree. They hire just fake people to be their fronts. That's it. That's why this show's so powerful. We're just telling folks what's in the white papers, what's really happening. We're not that smart compared to idiots we are. And we're just showing the real playbook, saying, see what happens. And once people understand, they go, whoa, really? And again, this whole thing is based on stealth. Anthony Gucciardi is going to take over for the next 10, 15 minutes, and then the next guest host comes in. Stations, I encourage you to pick up the show. Some stations won't get it. Infowars.com.
It's Operation Sleeping Giant, 28-hour broadcast. We're 4 hours into it. This is the fourth hour. I'm Anthony Gucciardi. That was a lot of fun with Alex. Now, to demonstrate the significance of this broadcast, 28 hours, which is actually a lot of time, a lot of manpower. Think about all of the people making this possible, all of the people staying here, 28 hours. Most people are going to stay 24 to 28 hours for this broadcast. But none of that means anything without every single person watching right now, sharing the streams, sharing the information, helping support the entire operation. So I want to say hats off to every single person listening. And you actually have to think about where we are historically, where we are in, if historically this was a mountain, we are reaching the peak. Things are getting so insane that it's time to be 100% unapologetic. It's time to be 100% brazen, because we get things like these stories that we're going to talk about, like the Olympics committee saying any non-sponsors are banned from tweeting about the Olympics. So if you're not a sponsor of the Olympics, you can't even tweet about the Olympics. You have things like regulators, this just came out today, want to allow more toxic chemicals in Florida's water. So how many times have we beaten back the toxic chemicals? They want to allow more toxic chemicals. They said a state panel will decide whether to declare higher toxin levels in drinking water. So just raise the levels. There's more toxic chemicals. It's good for you. It's totally fine. And, you know, there's been a lot of anti-police stuff that kind of puts us in a position of saying, you know, look what's going on. But we also have to remember things like this. Boston police use of cell phone trackers without warrants raises questions, and they're using this across the country. So what does that bring us to? It brings us to a point where they have openly screwed Bernie Sanders out of a nomination, whether you support him or not. They have. The anti-establishment message of a lot of people that followed Bernie was completely just hijacked. And now it's you are forced to worship Hillary Clinton, whether you want to or not. And the Bernie people are banned from the events and everything like that. It's total insanity. So what do? Instead of apologizing and sitting up here and being afraid and cowering in fear, we unapologetically stand boldly against it and all of this insanity. That is Operation Sleeping Giant. It's time to awaken the giant, not be crushed by the political, fake political correctness, the ideology prison that we let ourselves sit into. So that's why I'm unapologetically enthused about this, and so is everyone else here right now, and I'm honored to be a part of it, and thank you for being a part of it. So visit Infowars.com/giant to get the streams. Radio stations are open to carry this. After this hour, it is continuing on at Infowars.com/giant. And visit InfowarsStore.com. Even if you just want these unprecedented sales on the products, so they're the real deal. We don't cut corners. We don't use crap from China. We don't sweep off stuff off the floor and put it back on the conveyor belt. We use FDA-certified manufacturers. 40% off BrainForce. You've heard us talk about it. It's real. If you haven't tried it, you need to. It's the real deal. Look at the reviews. 20% off all water filters. 30% off Survival Shield X2, the flagship product that started it all. 30% off Super Male, Super Female. 20% off Survival Seeds. 20% off shirts. InfoWarsStore.com. This is your chance to support something great. Support greatness, not weakness. Stand unapologetically bold. I'm Anthony Gucciardi. We'll be back with more. InfoWars.com/giant to watch the 28-hour stream. Stay tuned.